Hello and welcome everyone to this very special Cardboard of the Rings Twitch stream. I'm Sean. With me tonight is a cast of characters. From Cardboard of the Rings proper, we have Chat.
Hello.
And then honorary Cardboard of the Rings members, we have some scrubs of Discord. Dave, or Stokesbook if you prefer.
Hello.
And Daniel, or Big Foam Loaf, or Big Foam Loaf, or Big Foam Loaf, or Big Foam Loaf, whichever one it works. I don't know what the phonics are.
It is Big Foam Loaf. Hello, everybody. Daniel in real life. So, all right.
And tonight, sorry for a little bit of delay on the stream itself, but that was because we're actually ready to play the game. Look at that. Okay, so tonight we're going to play through the first quest in the Flame of the West box, the Passing of the Grey Company. We'll give it a few minutes here before we actually get started so that people can kind of filter into the old Twitch stream here, because I know that a lot of people wait to get that email because, you know, let's be fair, Cardboard of the Rings has a bit of a proven track record of starting about 40 minutes late.
You know what would be helpful as well? If you bloody announced it in a bloody Discord channel.
Well, see, I have people like you to do that for me, Dave, because you're more forward-thinking. A little bit more Johnny on the spot, if you will.
Right. Chad, get off my lap.
Oh, but I like it.
I know you do, but not right now. Save it for the bedroom.
Nice.
All right, well, I'll go ahead and be that guy. It's my Discord server. I'll do what I want! So,
what am I hearing?
What are you hearing?
Oh wait, I know what it is. I'm trying to get the Twitch stream going. I think I had a stupid commercial.
Yeah,
I have it on mute.
All right. So
the advert cares not for your mute.
No, the advert really, really doesn't. It gives zero Fs about your mute. So we got Chris Jackson in the chat. Hello, Chris. We've got Vardane Lemonhead, who I believe is James from Discord. Tipsy Gamer, hey dudes. Vardane, here's Michael Caine, because, you know, that's just a thing. You know what, Dave? Let's just go ahead and dive into that for a quick second here. Are you from the same general geographical region as Michael Caine?
Where is Michael Caine from, for starters?
I don't know. But I do know that in the UK, region matters for your dialect probably more than anywhere else.
Let's ask Google.
So, all right, if we're going to go ahead and analyze this further, what region of London are you from?
Oh, God, it is actually pretty close. Holy crap.
I fucking knew it.
There it is.
Go on.
It's literally... Oh, that's really bad. Hold on.
So you're now living in Michael Caine's childhood house? Is that what I'm hearing?
Hold on.
He lives below.
Hold, please.
All right. Welcome, BRG 9000, Borgoran, or Bogoran. Vowels are hard today, guys. Definitely know you guys.
It's literally a 20-minute car ride from where he was born, apparently.
Okay, wow. So it's not out of the realm to compare your accent to that of the national treasure that is Michael Caine.
Not really, but we'll go with it.
Okay. So before we digress even farther, I think it's probably okay to get this thing started. So let's talk about Passing of the Grey Company. We're headed into the Forbidden Door. Chad, would you be so kind as to read the text for us here? In a voice, if you so choose.
I must take new counsel for myself and my kindred. We must ride our own road and no longer in secret. For me, the time of stealth has passed. I will ride east by the swiftest way, and I will take the paths of the dead. Aragorn, the Return
ride
of the King.
Ride we will. So we've set got Stone of Eric and the Army of the Dead aside out of play. We're each going to get a copy of Overcome by Fear to our threat dial, which we currently don't have because Octagon. So we've just got them neatly placed in our play area here. Overcome by Fear is going to be an objective burden, which is not a condition. Setup. attached to your threat dial. One per threat dial. Your threat cannot be reduced. Sad.
Boo!
Sad days.
Wah, wah.
Of course, at the end of the round, raise your threat by one, and then spend one fellowship resource, which, by the way, you can only do if you're the controller of Fellowship Aragorn here, to detach Overcome by Fear and set it aside out of play. Also, really, really, if we're talking about our respective decks here, first place is probably the worst place I could have hoped to be sitting, is essentially it.
Yes.
So, good on me for seeing that ahead of time.
Why?
Well, because at the end of the refresh phase, you're going to get Aragorn before I have a chance to trigger that effect. So I'm going to have to go four rounds before I have a chance to get rid of mine.
But that means you can use card draw on other people.
Nope. Oh, other people.
Yep. Oh, I can use the card draw on other people. But I definitely can't use the threat reduction. So, yeah.
You could use it once Stokes removes his.
Yeah.
See, and one funny thing about this is Lemonhead went ahead and recommended that people play Follow Me, which it would seem is a great play, but I do think that the way the timing works out is since the force triggers at the end of the round, which only occurs once, even if you're playing Follow Me, the best you can do is choose who gets to reduce or get rid of their Overcome by Fear that round, and sadly not get to, like, discard them. Multiple copies of it. But
has everyone got their hat visibility shown?
Yeah, definitely do that. All right.
Visibility.
So, go ahead and flip that card there, Chied.
I'm not running it.
Dave?
Nope, he's
Daniel.
Not running it.
Daniel?
There you go.
Oh, I gotta pass control. Sorry.
Third time's what? Charm.
Chad, there you go.
Damn,
I was downloading images.
Images of what? Sorry?
Chad, it's on you now.
All right.
I'm still waiting for the flippy flippy here.
Oh, we're both trying to do it. There it goes.
She is pretty. Okay. When revealed, each player may add this. Okay, so I'm going to talk about this after I finish reading it because this is a really cool thing for me. And I hope it is for everyone else. When revealed, each player may add one resource to the resource pool of each hero he controls. Each player who does so must raise his threat by three. Enforced at the end of the planning phase. Discard all cards in each player's hand and advance to stage 2A. So if anyone's a listener of the podcast and was listening to our episode 100 where we talked to Nate French about the original design. This might not have been episode 100. It might be the one where we talked to Nate the first time. Anyway, one of the times when we talked to Nate French. He talked about the original design of Escape from Dol Guldur from the core set. And talked about how instead of losing a hero, you instead discarded all cards in your hand. But the problem with that was it led players into a metagame where you just tried to mulligan for the worst hand possible instead of the best hand possible. So that wasn't good. So this is brilliant that they've brought this back, but that when revealed now gives you the option to try to belch out as much of your hand as possible, thus disincentivizing you from trying to mulligan into the worst hand. I think it's brilliant.
Speaking of which, I need to take a mulligan. So I haven't done that yet.
Fair enough. So anyway, I just wanted to call attention to the fact that even though it was an abandoned idea, Caleb was able to harness that power and turn it into something really awesome. So, props there. I'm good. I mulliganed once already.
Can I read the flavor text?
Oh, please do.
What was that, Chad?
Evil duo. I want to read the flavor text.
Oh,
this
yeah.
Is an evil. God, damn it! Okay. This
which,
is
which
an evil
flavor,
door.
Which text? Okay, rule of
good night, everybody. Good night. See you later. All right. I'm not going to do it now. Move on.
No. No. Get in there.
No, 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 no.
No. No.
I had a joke all lined up, and now it's going to be like...
Stupid. Let's just like, summarize. It's you're only supposed to blow the evil door off. There you go.
There you go.
Oh, okay.
Wow.
I'm not going to talk about the level of meta-ness on that one. Okay, so who wants to go ahead and raise their threat by three for extra resources? I will. Go ahead and control.
I will.
I will. Well, not. I will offset AoE minus 3 to get more. So.
Hey, Sean. When exactly is the resource phase on the first turn to play Captain's Wisdom?
Now. Seems good.
Yeah.
Okay. And chat, if you control N, I think that gets us ready to go. Oh, no. He's going to go away and it's going to be sad for me. Oh, maybe not. Maybe not. I could be very, very selfish, but also very, very altruistic, guys. I'm telling you. Let's see. We're going to go ahead and... This is tough. Did anyone not find a card they were really hoping for in their mulligan? You guys are all sitting pretty.
I'm okay.
Okay.
I wouldn't mind seeing Herodrim, but I can't pay for it anyway.
Oh,
so don't worry
about that. That's a big piece then. Okay, so I'll hold off on Galadriel. What I will do is pay 1, 2. Sorry, Dave. Let's see, what do we need? 3, 4, 5 for an Overhill, Underhill, Gandalf, because I like to live dangerously in a threat-raising quest.
Did you use all our fellowship resources to do that?
I may have, but watch why. And I'll pay 3 for Shadowfax on said Gandalf. So now we have 4 free questing and 2 ranged and sentinel at 4 stats. So try to balk at that. I don't think you can.
That's a good start.
Oh, what card do I want to get rid of?
Pass play.
I'm going to gain in strength. Over here.
Cool. Oh, gaining strength.
Over line.
Saying somebody's really loud. Is it me? I'm talking
no,
right
it's
now.
Big Fan Loaf, I think.
Okay.
I turned down.
Oh, okay, yeah, that might sound better.
God. Someone has their Twitch volume on.
I can't hear it. It's probably you.
Yeah, have you turned on? Have you turned down your volume since we started the stream? Because you might need a couple more notches down.
All right, how's that?
Turn down more, please.
that's 30 seconds behind. I think it sounds okay. We'll definitely
Are you sure?
Mention
That's
it
fine to me.
If it comes through. I'll let you know the next time you clip. Let's say that. All right, so we got a Dunedain warning. We have a Rivendell bow. Solid starts, I feel.
And I pass planning.
Oh, God. Okay, so I played Daron's runes.
All of these, though. Oof.
I played Daron's runes, and I'm having like an absolute ridiculous time trying to decide what to get rid of.
Oh, poor baby. Well, you're going to get rid of most of it anyway at the end of planning, so don't be precious.
Nope. I'm going to be able
get
to
rid
play
of Stuart.
Everything.
You're going to be able to play everything you say? All right. Nope. No help. Let him figure it out. That's a brag. I want to see this happen.
I'm going to maybe get rid of my own runes.
Okay.
So I get 2 more.
Okay. All right. I'm seeing things coalesce here. This seems pretty decent.
That goes there.
Oh, we're about to see some swarming action.
Then I can do that.
That's okay. Anyone play Nelrod? No? Okay, that's unfortunate.
I can do that.
Are you going to trigger either of their effects?
No. And okay. I don't think I should, unless someone wants me to.
I don't think anyone has terribly enticing targets.
Okay, 1, 2, 3. Then I can play that. And then I'm going to play that. For 8.
Why did you pay 3 for the Citadel Custodian?
I played 1.
Oh, you did.
3
okay.
For the veteran.
Oh, okay. Never mind. Sorry. My bad.
Oh, poo. There it is. Okay.
So I got a new PC. I don't know where the microphone is to turn down. So I've been looking for it. Windows 10, if anyone knows where that is on the Twitch stream. Are you done, Dave?
Swarm.
I'm done.
Swarm.
Gondor swarm. Complete.
Oh, Wed, you emptied your hand. Okay. Well, that deserves a slight, kind of understated round of applause.
Thank you. Thank you.
Wow. All right. You still got two resources left. I'm going home.
Yeah, so technically I didn't even need the... I kind of did the play Warden, but I could have got a Doom... Doom 2 could have got him in.
Aristor gives no shits about this quest. There are shits, but yep. Aristor wow. gives none of them. It's amazing.
Am I planning?
You are.
Gondorian shield on Baragond. Snowmane.
Master's Bane.
And I think I will actually play out the spirit in the other version of this deck. I had Frodo, so that's why I have Sam here, but I will play him.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. Fair enough.
All right, boys, that's the end of the planning phase, so go ahead and ditch that hand.
Okay, done.
Oh, you terrible person, you. Okay. Oh, wow, really? Stuart on Boromir? I didn't even see that. Not on old Denethor? Care to explain that tactical choice?
Is there other Gondor? Oh, there is other Gondor people. I always want to keep resources on Boromir for visionary leadership and his own ability.
Fair enough.
I'm keeping my Elven Lights out of my disco pile.
Okay.
It'll help anybody's Gondor allies and visionary leadership's ability.
Dave, do you have anything that targets the top event or top card in your discard pile? Anything that we need to be concerned about for rules snafus? I mean, let's be fair, not that we're terribly concerned about rules snafus, but... Okay.
There
enough.
You go, Paul.
To 2A!
Windows 10 thing. I think I have to take control of this, too.
All right. While you reveal that, I'm going to run to the bathroom because I'm drinking a little bit of local IPA called Sweet Child of Vine, and it's wonderful.
Ugh. It better taste better than the pun.
Tipsy Gamer, I could, I guess. I don't know. I just always put it on Boromir. I guess there's no reason not to put it on Denethor.
I don't know, though. I think worst case scenario Second.
All right. Jay Johnson 111 is teaching me how to turn my mic down. Hold on a second. Right-clicking the volume control. All right.
Well, someone's turkey is done.
Yeah, I could pass it. I guess if I put it on Denethor, then I could also pass it to Baragon.
It doesn't like
Eleanor.
The worst case scenario, if you have to kill Denethor, your deck doesn't fall apart. Yeah. Much as it with that many allies on the table, it's going to fall apart anyway, but still.
I usually end up spending almost all the resources I get, but. You know what? Because it's a four-player game and there's other Gondor heroes on the table, I do it this way. And we'll see how that decision goes. So right off the bat, I'm going to pass the one just to get it.
All right. Is the microphone better? I turned down the boost.
Yay!
That sounds really nice.
Sweet. All right.
Thank you,
Paul. And I learned something. Thank you, Jay Johnson 111. All right.
That's Paul. He is very, very cool. Okay, so I advanced the quest. He could see nothing but the... Man, this font is really hard to read. Dim flames of the torches. But if the company halted, there seemed to be an endless whisper of voices all around him. I don't know. A murmur of words. God dang, why is it so hard to read? Is it hard for you guys to read when you have
a
murmur?
It's just old.
Nope. Rude.
I'm just gonna throw it out there.
Oh, you know why? I have my window kind of minimized so I can see the chat going as well, so it's not as big as it could be.
All right, so we each get a different location and add it to the staging area. So, Chad, if you'd be so kind as to highlight our choices here. Or, Chad did.
I think there's only four different locations, so you might as well just bring one of everything.
I think there's five.
Stone of Erech is the fifth.
Is it really? No, there's a door. We haven't seen the door. Oh, there's the door. Damn.
I don't think there's any more.
All right, well, that keeps it pretty damn simple then.
What do we
then.
Say?
All right, Dan. So while Deadly Road is in the staging area, in order to crease a in order to cancel a when revealed effect, each player is going to raise their threat by three. Trysting place, isn't a tryst like a, isn't that a positive thing? Why would this be a negative thing to be at a trysting place?
I always thought it had kind of romantic.
Yeah, like.
Yeah, it's a romantic rendezvous.
It's like on par with a dalliance.
Yeah, I don't really want to do that with these people.
Anyway.
But, you know.
Don't knock it till you've tried it, let's face it.
So, while it's in the staging area, trysting place is going to prevent us from putting damage on enemies in the staging area, which is a thing. This was the main reason that I may have discouraged you from playing Dune here in this quest, Daniel.
Oh, that makes sense.
And then we have the Haunted Poth, which is going to get plus one threat for each player with a threat of 35 or higher. So that's going to get crazy as we go through. It's only a one now, but give it like two turns. And then Dark Door, which is going to prevent us from placing progress on locations in the staging area while it's also there. And yeah, I think that's bad enough in itself, so. Perfect.
Sean, is there a reason Aragorn does not have a resource?
I may have spent them.
Oh, okay.
He completely Brandoned the first turn.
I did it for an altruistic, selfish purpose.
I think that you were right to
that. That's not a thing.
All right.
It's an oxymoron, which is kind of a word you could use to describe Brandon as well. But
there could be no turning back. All the past people were unseen hosts that filed in the dark to return of the king.
Oh, he got it in. Look at that. Pro play.
Well, see, that one I could read. It doesn't have that crazy yellow background that was, I don't know, for some reason I just couldn't.
Wait, the quest points is the highest player's threat. Are you serious?
Yeah. So right now, this is at a 32.
That's what Chad.
It just gets worse.
Each player cannot reduce his threat beneath his, or below his initial threat level. And at the beginning of the planning phase, each player must choose to either raise your threat by one or choose not to play cards for that phase.
God.
So, bye, Bardane. Threat's the thing. Bye, Bardane. So let's quest, eh? So I'm going to quest for four. Five, six. Seven, eight? Seven, eight. We'll go eight.
I'll send six.
A threat reset from the plus three. Hold on. I'm in for five.
Yeah.
Oh, Stokes, are you at 32 as well?
Shush.
What do you say?
What do you say?
Blimey, cocky. Poppycock. Biscuits in a tin. Any of those things would have worked.
When did Dick Van Dyke join COTR?
Oi, governor, what you doing?
Oh, wow. God.
Chim-chim-chim-chim-chim-chim. Oh, sorry.
I think at this point this counts as cruel and unusual torture.
Hey, you opted to come on. You knew what you were in for.
Yeah.
Okay, so I think that's in for questing. Any actions before we start staging?
Nope. The dice in the most with one, two. I sent.
I'm gonna
five
go
characters.
With yes.
Okay,
I'm in for three.
So I could boost it by. I can boost it by five if I have to. Yep. Here we go. That guy.
All right. Oh, hey, and he's the first thing we've seen with the phantom keyword, which we should probably cover real quick. Phantom keyword means that in the combat step where damage is assigned, whenever damage would be taken by a character, that player, or the player who controls the character who would be taking the damage, instead
Wait, take
raises...
a guess. Someone take a guess.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm willing to bet that most people have seen the...
What could it be?
You raise your threat instead of taking
damage. No!
Which was why it was really fun to tell Dave earlier that I was bringing my Gloin deck to this quest.
To be fair, I said I was going to bring a completely healing deck before you said that.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how much play that Warden of Healing gets. There's a little bit of damage spread in this deck, but not a whole lot. Okay, so that's number one.
Wait a minute. So, can you chump?
There is no such thing as chumping, because that would just increase your threat by whatever the damage is, and the ally doesn't go away. So, yes, kind of. But the thing is
it's like
damage and defense in this game takes on an entirely different quality in this quest specifically. It's really interesting.
Huh.
So we'll get there in a moment.
Right.
And by interesting, I mean terrible. Okay, so Peril. This would be
Stokes,
Dave's card. When revealed, either attach a set aside overcome by fear to your threat dial, which you cannot do since it's already there,
so yes,
or
so
it makes
me.
An immediate attack against you, which you're actually pretty well prepared for, it turns out. All right, here defends. No shadow.
Hey,
no
nice.
Damage. No threat.
Threat.
Lovely.
Okay, card number three. Another one of these. Card number four. Well, no treacheries.
20 in the staging area, I think.
Okay, and that's to our, what, 25, 26? That was just a rough estimate. 14, 19, 25?
For 5 at the moment.
Anyone have any post-staging quest actions?
Yeah.
Nope.
Oh, there you go.
I can do 5 more.
So that makes it 30. So what, we make 10 progress? Not too shabby for a first round.
Pretty good.
Okay.
Right. We can't travel here because someone selfishly spent them.
That's like the least effective place to travel right now. Don't blame that on me.
I'm joking.
I'm thinking either
Sylvan Johnson
place,
is Paul.
I'm thinking either Trysting Place or Dark Door.
The first player searches the encounter deck for an Oathbreaker or... Hey, Paul. Haunted Path, no. Dark Door. Progress cannot be placed.
I would vote Dark Door.
Yep, I agree.
Okay, give me my encounter card as a travel effect. Discard. Oh no!
Oh no! Oh my god.
Here you go, boys.
Eleanor is gonna.
This is why we do it. It's not Peril, so Eleanor can totally cancel that.
Don't panic.
Woo!
I canceled it.
Raise your threat
by one.
That's fine. Totally acceptable. Oh, guys, I just about had a heart attack.
Okay.
Watch the next card is the same one.
Okay. Oh.
All right, so this is me. All right, so each character I control gets -1 willpower attack and defense till the end of the round. So that's fine. So that reduces my willpower overall by 3. Which doesn't matter because this is a travel effect, so no worries.
Yep.
So I just have to worry about the attack and defense. Okay, cool. And
regiments. I can take so the dead man of Dunharo, after it engages you, either attach a thingy or raise your threat by 2.
I'm happy to take one of those because I have low threat.
I think it was Dark 23. Here's that card that was so abhorrent. Either have to attach a set aside overcome by fear to your threat dial or discard an ally you control, which... For me, that's 8 resources worth of investment, so would prefer not to do that if at all possible. So thank God for Eleanor, who, by the way, is probably the most undervalued hero in the game. Just throwing that out there.
What about Spirit Pippin?
And Spirit Pippin.
Undervalued.
I'll take that one.
I can take okay, who wants Joseph to... Men.
Okay.
I
Dave,
have,
can you move these somewhere?
I'm taking control right now, buddy.
I have two actions with Gandalf. He has ranged and sentinel, and he is either defending for three or attacking for three. Just want to throw that out there.
All right. You wouldn't be able to kill it, would you?
No, not even with Gandalf's help. I'll defend mine.
Plus one.
So four against four, no damage.
Okay.
You mean no threat.
Same difference.
Let me see. I could swing for three with Gandalf's help ranged. What are you going to do? You're going to defend, and you're going to have one. Big Foam Loaf, why don't you use Gandalf's ranged?
Sure.
And I have two... Two attacks to deal out if you guys have your defenses handled.
Oh, yeah.
Shadowfax for the ready.
I have defense with Baragond, obviously. So
I'll be short one, but at least I can defend. Attack an enemy gets plus one. Oh.
Okay, so you take damage instead of threat this turn as opposed to the norm.
Okay. Sweet.
Which, what, only one damage? All right, that seems okay. Daniel?
Oops.
Baragond to defend.
There we go. Plus one. All right. No problem.
Pings off the wall of Baragond.
But I sadly don't reduce my threat.
Wop, 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 wop. Okay.
All righty.
Attack backs.
Big Foam Loaf is the only one that will die.
Well, okay, so I'll put two damage on someone's and then help Daniel kill his.
Oh, wait. Dave, what do you think?
Yeah, I think if you give it to me, I can hold back Questing and kill my next turn.
Okay, so Gandalf will swing for three there, and then also swing for three with, what, Eowyn, I assume?
Yep.
Yep.
Perfect, and he is deep.
Boom, dead. Whatever. I did that wrong, but it's dead.
Okay. You valiant warriors, you. Who wants some cards? I can give one to one and two to another. Chad, I feel like you're okay.
Yep, not me.
Dave, you've had two Elven Lights in your hand, so I feel like you're all right. So, Daniel, I'm going to go ahead and give the two to you, and I'm going to take
Thanks,
the
sir.
One.
Paul, free to choose would only work once we get rid of these overcome by fears.
Correct.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I think here, Chad, if you wouldn't mind grabbing that since it no longer applies, thankfully.
Sorry. Yep.
Would have been able to kill two enemies that round if it hadn't.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bummer.
I think that's a control N. At the end of the round, I'll raise my threat by two for Gandalf.
Everyone else, and then one for overcome by fear.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Done and done.
Okay, don't forget we have this forced effect.
Yep, so I'm going to raise my threat by one. Jesus is getting out of pan.
As am I. I can't not play that card.
Yep.
Just can't do planning phase. Well, I'm not going to increase my threat.
I'm going to play an Elven Mail.
Nice.
And I'm done planning.
Okay. I'm going to play this, which I'm very happy to see.
Nice, nice.
Get it up there. And I will play this.
Miss Unaffused or Unamused Manifest. Wow. Those words screwed up. That was the thing that happened.
It's a traffic jam in my mouth.
Like that. Then I will play this. I'm running out of space.
Repping leadership Gondor hard over there.
Like, yeah, holy crap.
I'm going to do this. Play another one of those. Oops. And then when I played Daron's Runes, this was my discard. I forgot to do it.
Yep.
My planning phase will be a little bit less eventful. I'm done.
Yeah.
Fair enough. Seems good.
I'm going to go ahead and pay two for Narya.
Stokes, you want to trigger error.
And for the love of God,
trigger
please
my what?
Don't have that treachery come up that discards an ally again. Daniel, I know you have my back with Eleanor.
I'm still there for you. Don't worry.
That's the treachery we cancel right now.
Okay.
Because guess what? We can totally get two uses out of Faramir and just like power quest the hell out of this thing.
Plus visionary leadership.
Ooh. Yeah, it's gonna be a thing.
I can't. I have to do that when you raise the threat. I can't pay to get rid of mine because you can only pay it at the end of the turn after you raise your threat by one.
Someone may or may not have used all of Aragorn's resources for a really,
yeah. I wonder who that was.
Really, 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 really good reason.
Oh, okay. Well, that's questy. All right. Gondor characters are plus one willpower.
I'm only questing for three this turn.
Six for me.
One, two.
This Chad's going to be questing for a billion.
Yes, he is.
Okay, 18 before I Faramir.
Love it.
That's good, though, boys.
That's real good. Okay. No pre-quest or no pre-staging actions for me.
Okay, I think we're ready.
Yep.
I'll assume that's a pass from everyone else. Here we go. Okay, that's the one.
Either
we cancel.
Attach.
I save Eleanor because I've got a test of will.
That's much better. We still have to raise a threat by one.
Totally acceptable.
Totally worth it. Here we go. Okay, Deadly Road. That was card number two. Card number three. Doomed one, of course. Why not? Each player with a threat of 35 or higher, that's almost everyone.
Oh no, Mary. Deals...
Oh no.
Mary.
Oh no.
Oh, is that the second one we cancel?
Yeah.
Well, do we enjoy questing?
Oh, yeah, those heralds are... Oh, God, so many things go away. Yeah, definitely cancel that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, God, now watch No Turning Back come up again.
Okay.
Oh, God, it was a treachery. I almost shat myself.
This is Daniel's.
That's horrible.
Catch a set-aside thing or progress cannot... No!
Oh, and that's... Why does that surge? Why does that surge?
Because it could just be you attached.
Okay, so unless Daniel has a test of will in his hand, that's just going to happen.
I don't.
Okay.
I don't.
I wouldn't expect this thing. You've only seen one other card, two other cards.
All right, here we go.
Yep.
Surge. Ah, oh, jeez.
What should we do with that one revealed?
I feel like our pace is actually pretty good. Oh, no. Peril.
All right. So.
I've already tainted the reasoning.
All right. Well, we're questing for a whole lot. I feel like even though we're not going to place anything, we can take another card. I will choose the additional encounter card.
All right.
Yeah, Ransom Man. That is correct. All right. I agree. Good choice. There is card 3C. And here's card number 4.
No. Wow, really? Game? Okay. That's going to not be good. Oh, well, progress can't be placed this round anyway. So outside of the initial crazy investment that you had going on, Chad, we really didn't lose anything but 6 allies. Oh, my God.
I'm sure you all feel better that I don't lose anyone, right? Okay.
Lame.
Yeah, we'll go with that.
What is the final count, however?
That probably does affect things.
I think I lost 1, 2, 3.
7, 8 in the staging area.
I lost 12. I lost 12 threat.
Oh.
Hi, Miss SRA.
Mysteria.
We made full progress.
But I gained 1 from getting my threat to 40.
How much did we make, Dave?
Full progress.
We get out of.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. That's actually perfect for the dark door.
That's all right.
It's not all right.
I mean, it's not great, but it's all right. It's okay.
Well, at least we got out of the location.
God, that treachery. That's so
bad. So we can try again.
Wait, did you add all the threats to this?
Oh, God, no.
Okay.
So that's 1 progress.
Does anyone
so 1 progress on the...
I'll Faramir, so we still...
Oh, okay, you hadn't done that yet. Okay, perfect.
We still clear.
Okay.
Right on. So let's manage some enemies. Yeah. No, wait, hang 30 on. 30
minutes.
Nah,
Ransom Man. I knocked that thing out. I knocked out that planning phase.
Oh, thank God we were talking about the planning phase. So I'm thinking a haunted path is okay as a travel candidate.
Yep.
Okay.
Agreed.
I'm glad that required no further discussion. Okay. again, I have the ability to ready again. So essentially I have 3 actions with Gandalf, 2 of which are going to be at 5 attack or 5 defense. So
that's cool.
Keep that in mind. As plan.
I can.
Oh, is that what you heard, Chad?
If you want.
I'm happy to take.
That's fine. That just means I'll be using Gandalf's abilities for myself a little bit as well.
I'll take. Deal with that.
You'll take that.
He attacks me, however.
What's it do?
I can defend that for you if you want.
Let me defend it, so that way Gandalf's turned on.
Sure. Thank you.
Okay, so Gandalf will defend.
Nothing.
Cool.
Nothing.
Narya, and ready Gandalf and the veteran of Osgiliath, and give them +1 attack and defense for the phase.
How can you Narya get... Oh. No. You have to exhaust the attached character to Narya.
Oh, do you? Aw.
Yeah.
Then I'll exhaust Shadowfax before I do that.
Right.
There you go.
I can take the Faithless Dead.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, so shadow.
Let us resolve the
shadow through cloud and hail.
I do. There's a feint in my hand if anyone needs it.
I think I'll be fine. Okay, so I'll defend the Faithless with Elra here.
Nothing.
And then I will defend the Ghosts with Elra here.
Nothing, which means I'm going to get shat on.
No, I got your back.
What does Narya give? +1 attack and defense.
So he's a 4-3 for attack and defense.
Hey, Eddie, no pants. He's a 4-3. That seems pretty good. Yeah. Okay. So he's fine. No damage. Or threat increase, I mean.
But wait. Right, okay. How much attack have you got on the board? Oh, you've got enough to kill it, don't you?
I can swing for 5 and kill my own.
Yeah, all right, that's fine then.
I can throw five somewhere, whether it be defense or attack.
Are you defending with Baragon?
I am.
Either raise your threat by two or return this guy to the staging area.
Poor threat, huh?
We're closer to threaten out than you.
Yep, I'll raise my threat.
Yeah. Okay, attacks you, backsies. There should be a way for you to kill both your guys, Stokes.
Yeah.
Between Gandalf and Aragorn. And
so let's do Aragorn.
Thanks, Durin, Father.
Elrahir on the Ghost of Men.
Ghost of Men. That's dead?
Yeah.
Okay.
And hang on, what do we want to do about Shadow Host?
Shadow Host?
I don't believe it's possible for us to kill him this round. Oh, no, Elodin has range, doesn't he?
Yeah.
So his three, Eowyn's one, and Gandalf can do it.
Yeah, let's save it for that then.
Well,
okay.
You sure?
Okay.
All right.
Well, yeah, I kind of agree here. It's a four-threat enemy that Baragon can defend.
Like, over and over. But then...
Yeah, but
it might get shuffled back and show up again.
Right. But then I can't settle for you guys and stuff like that, so...
Well...
But I'd kind of rather see the enemy than a treachery.
That's also a good point. If we just keep filling out the enemies, then they're going to get
guys,
more treacheries.
Well, guys, the real music of the game comes in balance. So, really, what's taxing us the most as a player group right now? Is it that Dave's going to have to defend multiple things? Is it that Daniel's going to have to defend the most strengthened thing?
Over and over.
Here's another good question. Is when do we see this window opening again where we'll have enough attack to kill the Shadow Host? It could conceivably happen next turn.
Yeah.
So it might not be a crazy pressing issue.
Alright, so what, kill mine then?
Yeah, kill yours.
Okay, swing with Gandalf, kill mine.
Okay, then I'm swinging in for five. And nothing, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so delete.
That seems a pretty decent outcome. Okay. Yeah.
I will not trigger Eowyn's one-time ability.
Okay. Save that for the money.
Now come a day.
I'm gonna draw
when I do the sensible thing and go to bed instead of staying up watching COTR stream, which starts at 1:30 a.m.
But it is not this day.
This day, we watch.
So that triggers at the end of the round. Okay, who wants a card?
Me,
not me.
Take it.
Thank you. Okay.
Okay. End of the round. Overcome by fear triggers. So now Chad has Aragorn at the point that triggers.
Oh shit. Oh shoot. I forgot to raise.
Wait. Wouldn't Dave ability to dial? Thing off his dial?
No, because Chad gets it before end of the round. He moves during refresh, right?
Oh, wow. All right.
Well, I'm going to trigger it. So let's move it over here.
Oh, man. Okay.
Is that how that works?
Yep. Just
for me?
Yep.
Okay. I'll raise my threat by two for Gandalf. I'm really hoping. hoping these final turns pay off for me, because starting first is probably a terrible, terrible decision.
Alright, I'm first. Let me see if I need this. 1, 2, 3, 4.
I'm going to Elven Light back.
Does anyone need a resource added to a Gondor hero?
I have none.
I don't need it now.
Okay. Well, that option's always available. Okay, I'm going to play this guy. Move a resource. I don't really need to. And then I'm going to play these two yahoos.
Sean, would you be willing to bear a vor for me now?
I'll bear a vor for you now.
Thank you. Ugh. Thanks.
That's always just one here after an altruistic Barovor. Yeah.
Thanks. Fantastic.
So, who do we foresee is killing the most folk?
Eladan. That's Warhorse. Warhorse.
Yeah.
Able.
Seems yeah. good.
All right.
Gandalf obviously would be a better choice, but he can't take it.
Yep. I'm done.
I never noticed before because I don't think it's ever mattered, but Shadowfax is not freaking restricted.
Right.
Nope.
That's kind of stupid.
Where
Gandalf is concerned, it's not terribly relevant, but that never even occurred to me before.
Is it only his staff that's restricted?
Is that even?
I think it is.
Alright, we'll find out when I draw it.
It is.
I also Rovani Outrider, and I'm done planning.
Okay. I'll throw a Hobbit pony on Mary, because I guess why not? Protects him from the...
I have to raise my threat by one, don't I?
Yeah.
Yeah, good call, good call.
Yep.
Chad, do you have any compelling allies in your hand that it would be awesome to have hit play at no cost this turn?
I have no cards in my hand. I played them all.
Okay, well, I guess we'll be playing that then. I will pass planning.
I can't see your hand.
Elstone?
Oh. Nice. No, I should be fine.
I'm going to discard a card for Elven Light and pass planning.
Sea Grader, that's great.
You know, I think that's probably a thing that we could make happen pretty easily.
Well, that does sound like a good idea.
Oh, I think I gotta raise my threat by another one. Or did I do that? I can't remember.
I don't think you increased for planning. Oh no, you did.
I did?
Yeah, you did.
Okay. Alright. Are we questy?
We are questy.
Alright, let's try this again. Alright, I am sending... I'm sending 13 and hoping to God we don't get that treachery again.
Alright, I'm sending 4, 6, 7, and I'll put a progress on a...
Can't.
Why not?
These guys.
Is that thing...
Because Caleb likes hard counters.
No, that's enemies in the staging area can't take damage.
No, there's... Oh, enemies. No, Dark Door we traveled through. Yeah, no, we're fine.
Yeah.
If Dark Door was out there, for sure.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, I apologize. I totally misunderstood.
All right. So we'll put it on a trysting place, please.
All right, that's great.
And it gives the Rovanian another... So I'm committing 8.
Okay.
Okay. I'm sending three.
Okay, there's only...
Yeah.
Gentlemen, I'll be right back.
Okay, there's only six cards left. Let me see how many are in the discard pile that are terrible. So we can try to guess.
I feel like this is a really odd way to gauge how much hurt we're in for. But I understand it, is the thing.
There's only two copies of Blood Runs Chill.
So there's three of those.
Oh, God. The way is...
We've seen both of the discard ally ones, and I reckon we've got two more of the minus one to all stats.
The way is shut. There's only one of those in the discard pile.
Is there?
Not good. Yeah.
Well, there's probably three of those. Maybe two.
Oh, God.
Looking at a way is shut.
It was made by the dead, and the dead keep it. The way is shut.
Half of the cards in the encounter deck are treacheries.
Oh, cool. Yay! I'm glad we have one Eleanor, so at least maybe something can happen there.
But the advantage is, I think, no surge, and they're not the ally discard ones.
Silver linings.
Well, we can... Are everyone committed to the quest?
I believe so.
One of them is a Blood Runs Chill, though.
My blood runs chill. Oh, wait, that's the one that prevents progress?
That's the one that does a damage to all the exhausted.
Oh.
That would not be as terrible to me this turn.
Yeah.
Anywho.
All right.
Are we ready?
Yep.
Yeah. Replace a treachery with a different treachery. Okay, there's that. This is me.
Yep.
Either set or makes immediate attack.
I'll defend it if you want.
No, that's peril. Okay. Peril.
Oh.
Yeah,
You just got rid of the card.
I know, and I'm just thinking with the five cards left, and this was not a treachery.
So there's three treacheries and two other cards.
Yeah, we might get rid of one of these treacheries right here with the attack. Oh, God.
Do it. Do it. Do it.
It's peril. Shush. I'm going to do it. Hey, can someone black for me?
Peril.
Nope. Peril.
It doesn't block Sentinel. It just blocks if I decide to do the effect. Yeah, Pocket Race is agreeing with me here. Yeah. I had to look into that. I might have even asked the question. I'm not even sure.
Well, I'll defend with over here.
Yeah. Oh, okay, well, that happened.
I just couldn't have said, hey, if I take this, Stokes, would you have been able to... Will you be able to block for me?
That's fair.
Yeah.
Oh, really? I thought Peril meant you had to deal with every aspect of it on your own.
Nope, I just deal with the when revealed effect itself.
All right.
Okay.
Cool. Well,
yay.
That makes sense. Good. Now that the attack initiated by the effect is rolling, now that the...
Ooh, and you already readied them?
I already readied.
Good call. I'll just put that there just to remind you.
It's one of the Blood Runs Chills.
Okay, here we go. Card number two.
So the last two are going to be treacheries, and they're going to be Ways Shut and Whispers in the Dark.
This is a peril for Sean.
Dead and the dead keep it.
I can't do the overcome by fear thing, so the other thing happens.
Well,
a valiant effort.
Do you not want me to Eleanor that?
You can't because it's peril.
Yep, peril.
Oh, yeah.
Wait.
We're completely screwed. Again.
Then I think we're going to lose the game.
We are going to lose the game.
Quite possible.
So if you take the Overcome by Fear...
I can't, because I have one.
Oh, you only can have one?
It says limit one per threat dial.
Oh, I thought you were saying it like, I can't, like, I refuse to.
No, I straight up have no choice to make.
Yep. On the plus side, that's the third card. So it's going to surge into the last card in the encounter deck.
Silver lining.
I thought you said there was no...
I said there's one surge, so Whispers in the Dark. There you go.
And this is who, Dave?
This is your Surge.
This is yours, it's Surge.
This is me? Why does that card have Surge? Okay, well, I guess there's nothing to be done about that, so bring it on.
There is one card left in the account deck.
Yep.
This is my one. When revealed, or reveal an additional encounter card, I have to raise my threat by 2 then.
Well, why don't I just...
Each player's threat by 2, Dave. Each player's threat.
Oh! Well, yeah.
But peril. Just rules clarification and then peril.
Well, there's no more encounter cards, is there?
Well, it's the quest phase.
So they reshuffled. Oh.
Yeah, we'll keep getting them.
Yeah, encounter card. Give it. Bring me.
Octagon automatically shuffles it in. And it would have, because we're still in the quest.
Yeah, we're still staging.
So I think both these treacheries should technically be in the deck, right?
Yes.
Okay.
I think that's a thing we commonly get wrong on Octagon, because it's so easy to just want to leave them there.
Yep.
Shuffle.
So reveal another one. Prepare for the search train, boys. Oh, there we go.
Okay, those are both fours.
That's right.
Fives, I mean. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 13 plus 10, 23. Well, we can't place progress. 25 to our 28. That's 3. Now we gotta double check my math since we're this close. Hey, Wandering Took.
Have you used Faramir yet? 5, 6, 7.
No.
It'd be nice to get out of.
Oh, I know. This location. I'm just seeing if I don't have to. 23, 25. I count 25 again.
Yeah, 25.
Okay. Well, Faramir it is. Well, this is really lame that we cannot place progress on the quest.
Yeah, that's.
But I have.
Hey, let's shut down an entire.
I'm going to save Gandalf
the game and the rules.
What was that, Daniel?
I'm going to save Gandalf's life, or I'm going to protect him as soon as we travel.
Okay.
So let's travel. All
right.
What do you know that I don't? I'm scared.
Okay, we're not traveling to Deadly Road.
Oh.
There you go, Sean. You're protected.
Wait,
from that one treachery.
If you draw that thing that kills an ally.
Oh, I see. Okay, right on. Watch it.
I really hope we get not killed. So,
you want to travel here? I can take an enemy. There's only one in this. Oh, there's two in the staging area.
Yeah.
That's fine.
Take it to
me. All right. I will take.
So then I don't need Eleanor to get that one revealed. All right.
Then we get rid of that one revealed effect. Okay, optional engagement. I basically already took mine. Do you want one in addition to the one you got? Or are you good?
I don't need another one.
I'll take a Ghost of Men.
All right. Let's see. Well, I have 6. I can kill him. What's Gandalf going to be able to do this turn, Sean?
Lots of things. Whatever you guys need him for.
So, Dave, you can't ready Elra here if he defends, right?
Well, I've got no resources to ready him anyway, so it doesn't matter.
No, but he doesn't. Does he?
He doesn't what?
He wouldn't ready.
Wasn't there some effect?
Phase?
Oh, well, shit.
Oh, that's okay. Give Dave's dude a shadow card.
No, wait, but it's better if you defend for Chad, because Chad's the only one that can lower his threat. And then Gandalf defends for you. I mean, I can eat Elrahir next turn.
Well, I have a feint and a tireless hunters that I'm happy to play and drag someone over here. So
I think it might be better if you feint mine. Mm-hmm. You defend one for Chad. Sean defends yours with Gandalf. And then we worry about killing stuff. So then Chad's
the
needs
beauty of the future is he defense. Gets rid of. So you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's good stuff. Hey, secondhand Took, how are you? Okay. So I have two
enemies. Alright, so hold on. Before am I tireless hunting? Dragging someone over.
Wait. Because I've got there seems to be a lot of plus attack shadows in this deck. And if we get one of those, I can ready the person that defends and they can kill it. So
okay.
I'd rather not discard the shadow cards because the shadow cards are weak apart from the plus attack, I think.
Okay. All right, so I guess I don't understand.
Well, don't tireless hunter, no. So he's, Barragon's still going to defend one of yours. But I don't think we need a tireless hunter.
Well, actually, I would like the tireless hunter so I can use Eleanor as a blocker against one of those three strengths and know I'm only going to lose one.
Lose that one what?
Again, I'll lose one threat. Nice. By one instead of something else, right?
Right.
So
that seems okay.
Yeah, let me tireless hunter one of Chad, one of your dudes.
Okay.
And
nice. Get rid of its card. When a shadow discard hits an actual shadow effect because so often it's like, oh, discard blind. Oh, no shadow effect. Well, I did nothing.
Right. All right, so now defense, right?
Yep.
Okay.
So you're defending your two with your two heroes.
Yeah.
No. If he defends yours with Barragond, you get to lower your threat by one if he doesn't take any damage, right?
Then
Sean can defend the Shadow Host for Daniel.
Okay, I like that idea.
Okay.
You defend for me.
I will be honored to.
Plus one. No idea. You'll be honored. Wow. Thank you. Look at this. Dropping threat. Whee!
Do we actually...
Okay. Right, but hold on. So I play this. Tides of Fate. Barragon gets plus three defense, so he's at stupid level, like nine defense. And I'll pay two to ready him, and he gets plus three attack next attack this phase. So you can kill.
Oh, now, awesome. It's the first time I've seen that card played.
Are we able to lower?
Not if you have the Overcome by Fear attached to your threat dial.
Yeah, that's right. Okay.
Only Chad right now.
All right. So Barragon stands back up.
He's got plus three attack this phase against his next attack.
Great. All right. So, Chad, you can discard the shadow card on you, and then Gandalf, you're host?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're supposed to do it at the end of the round, so I'm just holding it. Or at the end of the combat phase.
All right.
Okay, who's defending? Why don't you do Eleanor against the one that you know?
Okay, I'll raise my threat by one.
Okay, Gandalf's defending shadow host. So it's stacking for five.
Okay. Ooh.
Shadowfax to ready Gandalf, Narya and Gandalf to ready Gandalf, and who else?
Narya can't ready Gandalf.
Sure you can. As long as you're able to exhaust Gandalf.
Yeah.
Gandalf is one of the best targets for Narya, it turns out.
Yeah.
Did Gandalf take a damage?
No, because now he's got five defense.
Now he's plus five defense before the damage resolves.
Oh, that's amazing.
And someone ready an ally and give it plus one attack and defense this round. I'm assuming veteran of Isgiliath. but I could be wrong.
I don't need it because I have Aragorn and Boromir.
So ready
to help you,
Angie.
Sure. So then Sam's a 2-2.
Okay.
Got a couple things to swing at in front.
I'll defend mine.
Okay. So he's not going to be able to ready at the start of the...
No.
Okay.
Oh.
All right. We'll defend that with Baragond.
Okay, yeah, so he takes no damage. Or I could...
faint if you wanted.
Oh, yeah.
Is it really worth a faint?
Or Sam could... Well, Baragond... do we want Baragond to do it, or... It seems like a lame faint if I can actually defend it.
Okay.
But then you got three attack you're wasting.
Yeah.
Kill your...
I'll have
still up.
Yeah,
I'll have three.
Oh no, Chad, what's happened?
I don't know. It's
Chad, you're just.
Okay.
Oh boy.
Not on my screen.
Not on my screen.
Oh, here it goes. All right, yeah, the orientation's going. It's fine.
It says that Chad is setting everyone's orientation.
Yeah, it does that when he's reconnecting, is when he's reassessed what the card that they're going.
So, Gandalf, are you coming to help Sam and Eowyn? Because that's the eight attack, right? Which could kill my Shadow Host. And then I'd be happy to defend you, Dave, and keep the feint. As long as I can kill one of those things in front of me.
You can do that anyway. Gandalf defends my extra attack.
Well, okay.
Either of which he's fine doing, so it just depends.
Gandalf has strength than Baragond does, even with his plus, right?
He's a 5-5 right now, yep.
He's a 5-5, and there's the most plus attack they can get in the deck is plus 2.
Right, and so Baragond is going to be attacking for 4. So if someone's going to defend that attack, shouldn't it be the guy who has less attack value?
Because you're saying Gandalf has 5?
Gandalf has 5 and can attack everywhere on the board.
In the end, it's not going to matter. You're not going to be able to kill both your guys.
No, I don't need to kill both if I can get rid of that Shadow Host.
Oh, you want to get rid of the Shadow
Host. The Faithless Dead doesn't really bother me very much.
We... 5, 4, 6. Yeah, well, you can get rid of you can swing with all your guys because Sam's a 2, Baragon's a 4, and Arion's a 1. So you can get rid of the Shadow Host on your own.
That's 7.
That's only 7, so I can't.
4 plus. Oh yeah. Well, I got Illidan.
Sent with me. All right. So I think I need Illidan Gandalf
extra ready. Even though it doesn't have a resource, I forgot about that.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. So getting back to actual turn order here, has this guy been?
So just pick one. Just pick one.
I'm defending it, Gandalf.
Okay.
There it is.
Yep.
Okay.
All right. Okay. Attacks back. Swinging for 6 to kill my guy.
Okay. Gandalf, are you coming with me?
Let's do it.
Shadow Host. Alright,
thank you. Shadow Host.
Killed by Shadow Fax.
Nice.
I know.
Yeah, what are you swinging for there, Soaks?
Just 3. So I'll put 2 damage on mine.
Okay. Whew. All right.
Okay, refresh.
This guy goes here, so we can get rid of...
I really felt like we could have killed 2 enemies the other way instead of 1. 3 enemies instead of 2.
Well, yeah, but we got rid of the bigger enemy, was the thing.
Big guy.
We still could have got rid of the bigger enemy. Because I could have swung in with Illidan, with all these 3 characters. The Shadow Host would have been dead. Your 5 would have still been up to kill the faithless dead, and Chad killed his. That's three enemies instead of two.
Retcon!
I forgot Eladan had a ready.
But he didn't have a resource.
But he's got a warhorse.
No, he's got warhorse. I forgot about
that
too.
That seems fair.
Okay, so your enemy.
I never feel bad, Dave. Smart. So should we pretend that we know stuff and kill more people?
Oh, that's currently the MMO. Or the MMO. Wow. Words tonight. They're not a thing. That's
is it Faithless Dead that would have died? Stoke?
Faithless Dead, yeah. Because it's five health. Five in total.
Does the Ghost of Men still gets damaged?
Still gets two damage because I would have been readied after the Shadow Host killed with Eladan. Yeah.
Yep. Sorry about that, everybody. Yep. Warhorse was hiding.
Stokes, I'm a little played faint to do that or not?
No.
Nope.
Okay.
Nope, we got it. All right, you want to remove your threat?
I'll be using Aragorn's thing to get rid of that overcome by fear.
Yep.
And ready for next round.
Chad, I'll... Oh, God, I really wish I could reduce my threat. Chad, I'll go ahead and reduce yours and let you draw a card. Oh, but you're going to discard the card. Crap. Daniel, go ahead and draw a card and reduce your threat.
Yeah, math.
That was a good draw.
Ooh.
Test of will.
All right. We might actually be able to place progress this round.
That would be a thing.
Oh, I drew Gandalf.
I got an Elven Light.
Yeah, look what I can't play.
Let's
see. Oh, I might take the
I'm gonna
not
dip
play
out
cards
again
this
for a
round.
Quick second. You guys, you keep it rolling.
I'm going to not play in the planning phase.
I think
so. I won't reduce my threat, or I won't get threat.
I think I'm going to do the same thing. I don't need to play these cards, even though I could.
Yeah.
Dark 293. We thought about it. The problem is you have to control Aragorn to do that effect. And I don't know. It seems like...
I feel like considering how much we've been cock-blocked for progress, I think the Gandalf first turn wasn't as big a deal as maybe getting rid of the threat early.
I agree. Especially because this is my threat reduction and I can't do it.
I don't know. I mean, Gandalf and Shadowfax first turn, I get why that's a seductive idea.
Yeah, it is. But
and then when he threats out, it's not going to matter.
Yeah, because we can't get clear the stage, and we're revealing enough cards every turn that it's going to come up. So basically,
so now this
our cancel priority was discard an ally instead of him not being on the table, and it should have been blocked the progress. Should have been our cancel priority.
Yeah, we would have already been on the second stage of the quest.
Yes, Sean.
Dark 293. The follow me does not trigger at the right time. The person you can't.
Because the
can't pass Aragorn
ability
around.
To remove the overcome by fear is on the overcome by fear, not anywhere else. It happens at the end of the round.
Good thought. We thought the same thing.
We hoped the same thing. Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So we're all in agreement that Sean is ruining the quest for everybody.
Yeah.
Okay.
With what did he call it? Selfish altruism.
Selfish altruism.
That's not a thing.
Yeah. So the very impossibility of it has ruined us.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
That's like saying I'm modestly boastful.
We blame you for everything.
Nothing. All nice comments.
There were several buses drove by and you were thrown under all of them.
I'm good for that. Yeah.
Sean, actually what happened is myself and Dan decided not to play a card this round.
Yep, so it's your planning.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I have to make that decision, don't I? Before I start spending resources. We're planning on making progress this round, aren't we?
It would depend. Now
we're going to make progress this round, aren't we?
Yeah.
Well, you can lose an ally now, so we don't need to worry about that treachery.
Okay.
Only have one ally in it? Seems kind of silly.
Well, it's not good against the discard an ally quest, Chad. We'll just go ahead and say that. He is poorly positioned to deal with that treachery.
But play better.
I mean,
Sean, where's your hobbit pony?
What, this one?
You got one? Oh, okay, there. Couldn't see it.
Oh, okay. I thought you were setting me up for some kind of wombo combo joke. So we'll go ahead and pay... Oh, no, not damage, two. We'll pay two for an evening star, and we'll go ahead and just get rid of that trysting place before that location comes out that prevents me from doing so.
Nice.
And then I suppose we'll pay five and hardcast ally Glorfindel, because he's awesome.
Nice.
And that's enough for me.
You are encroaching on my side of the board, though. I'm starting to get annoyed.
Hey, boys. What are you doing? Whoa.
You like that?
What's the French word for 15? It's a menage or whatever that is.
What?
French word for 15?
Yeah.
Menage à 15. If that's what you're looking for.
All right. Questy. Does anybody need a resource?
No.
Terribly no.
Dave? Stokes, do you need a resource?
Oh, his Discord is defunct for a moment.
Okay.
Who can you pass it to? Just Gondor. Oh, you didn't have it.
No, I got.
Oh, you've got Aaron. Writers. Holy my God, you've got Trerend writers. I mean, I guess I wouldn't say no to resources. The best I can play next turn is an Elfstone for myself, which means I can't get any good allies into play. So it's a hard pass.
Chad, I'll take one on Eowyn. Could be useful. Thanks.
Whoa. Okay, never mind. You did it. You did it, didn't you?
What did I do?
You added one and I slid one over. Okay, I'm going to quest with the other two. Ah, where'd my visionary leadership go?
Are we questing?
We are questing.
All right, it will be two. I'll quest for eight, and let's put a progress on one of the deadly roads up there.
Deadly
Thank you.
Road, take me home to the place I want to. Oh my God, someone's cut me off by now normally.
I was counting.
All right.
And ignoring. I was ignoring counting.
Mm-hmm.
Sean, I was enjoying.
Okay, looks like all the willpower has been added up. Here we go.
God.
All right. It's at the right
person. That is Daniel's.
Do you want to do this? You do have an option. It's peril. You do have an option.
Yep. I will take Overcome by Fear back.
That's probably a good play.
I agree. Okay, here's your Surge, because why not? Okay, there's that.
Surge? Can we talk about that for a minute? That's a game-crushing card. And it surges.
It is demoralizing that that card has Surge.
Moving on.
I don't know why it has Surge. It cannot whiff.
I can't think of any other card in this encounter deck, absent this card, that is more deserving of Surge, or that is less deserving of Surge, rather. I don't know.
I don't know, man. I mean, but he picked the right moment in the books for that card. I mean, it's the It's the epitome of this quest.
I should have brought my Rossi on deck because I would have got great pressure out of doors closing the way it's shut.
Yeah. Yeah.
I love that sentence so much.
That's meta. That's cool. All right, here we go. Sean's card. There you go. That's no problem. Stokes's card. All right. I'm enjoying this. My card. Each player must choose. That's no problem.
I'd really prefer that that doesn't happen. Well, I mean, I suppose why? I could get rid of the Curious Brand. But...
yeah, it's going away anyway.
Wait a minute. Why don't I test of will that so we can just be done with this staging?
I'm not going to complain about a test of will.
Wait, you had...
do we all... okay.
You had test of will when the way is shut came up?
Yeah, but I just thought I don't care about taking the extra threat right now. I was planning for Eleanor and test of will.
Okay, I'm sorry. No. I'm sorry. I read that card wrong. I thought it was an each player thing. So, all right, never mind. That totally didn't matter because you took the overcome by fear. Right. Moving on. Sorry, deep misunderstanding of how that worked.
Although, do we care about losing an ally? I can actually save test of will.
The Brandy Buck doesn't matter. I can definitely get rid of this Aaron Rider.
I can't take either option because I've got an overcome by fear and I don't have any allies.
And you would lose either Sam or your Outrider.
I think we just eat it. We can save the tested wheels for ways shut. Well, I mean, we have to get them to line up. But...
yeah, I think that's solid. Let it happen.
Okay.
The Curious Brandy Buck killed for a very good reason, so let's let that happen.
Okay.
And all right, that's so thank you for that.
There.
A little willpower loss, but not a big deal.
Lost okay, two on that.
So. That goes away. Thank God. I think we're actually going to clear this. Okay. 2, 4, 14, 18, 20, 22. Where are we at? We're at 29.
13, 16, 29.
I'm sorry. I'm so in for two seven. More because Mary now pops in.
We have 31.
We could Faramir twice, nine potentially.
Partners. So 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. Faramir for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 more. Oh my god, it's not going to be enough.
I could trigger, totally I could let Faramir trigger again.
Yeah, we totally should.
Okay, ready Faramir.
Oh, 7. Sorry, I miscounted. So then 7 more. Wow. If I had, of course, hadn't lost all my allies, I think we could have done it. But it is what it is.
It certainly is.
We're at 30 progress on the quest. All right. Who did Gandalf raise up? Faramir and who else?
Himself.
Himself?
Okay.
Did you boost your threat or your willpower any, Sean?
Oh, no, it had no effect on willpower.
Just attack and, yep. All right, where are we going? Let's see. We either get probably this one.
Yeah.
That seems fine.
Come on, can't place progress on the quest treachery.
Was Dark Door there at the beginning of this quest phase? I can't remember.
No.
No.
No, okay. It got staged.
Oh, look at that.
Right. Oh, glory, glory, hallelujah. Yeah. Wow.
Oh, look at all the threat increase.
Yeah.
God.
They're coming down.
Keep in mind, I suppose we let it higher than it actually is because I'm keeping Gandalf and helping you guys out. So just when you're taking that into your calculations, keep that one in mind.
Yeah, Gandalf's really a big help. Thanks.
By the way, I forgot to put a resource on Aragorn.
Huh? Oh.
I didn't have control of him.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. Yeah. All right. Okay.
Good night, buddy.
Thanks, Red Chrysler.
I can't really take another one.
I took one.
I obviously would take one.
I think you're getting two. Unless
do you guys have the option of letting me or me allowing you to draw cards or me taking
I'm
an
happy
enemy.
To take two of these dudes.
Okay, you gotta raise your threat by four total.
Ugh.
What it is, right?
Threat quests are always the worst.
Well, that's what we get for mentioning that for that threat is not a threat anymore. That's what happens to us.
Whoever said that is an idiot.
I know. What assholes.
Does anyone need to not deal with an attack?
Me.
Okay.
I agree.
Done.
Okay. Hey, that's good. That's real good.
So then I will have Eleanor defend one of them. You choose, Chad.
There it is.
Good choice.
Thank you.
Bounce, and then Berg on the other.
All right, that means I'm getting a terrible one.
And sadly, my Overcome by Fear is back. Ugh. All right.
Oh, look at that. No shadows except... No shadows. Wow. Okay, I have no attack back.
All right, so I will have Eowyn and Aragorn kill one of my dudes.
Okay.
What's Gandalf got? He's got two attackies?
He's got two attacks at four.
So Gandalf, can you can kill...
I could kill Daniel's other one. Dave, yeah. What are you
and
looking
at? Well, hang on.
Well, Dave could swing over for three. Shoot.
Hold on.
Holding.
Hold?
Why wouldn't Gandalf kill the two that... One in front of me, one in front of Chad.
Well, yeah, I guess that probably makes more sense.
Okay, so I'll swing into Daniels.
And I'll do two damage to mine.
And I'll kill Chad.
And I'll then do
it. I need it now because they were here. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Sean, can I lower my threat by one, please?
Go ahead. Take a card, in fact.
Sorry to waste a card. Yeah, watch it be something. Ah!
That's good.
It's
going to go. Oh, God!
Then I'll let Daniel draw a couple cards.
Of course I draw that right now.
Why is Dave upset?
Because I drew
Celebrant Stone and it's going to get discarded before we can play it on Aragorn. And then he stops. He doesn't exhaust the quest.
Why will it be discarded?
Because they're a rare store.
Well, can it go on him right now?
Not at the end of the turn. Rush.
Plus, I also can't play cards of that phase. Never mind.
Because it would enter his hand during the refresh phase.
I should have done this.
Oh, that's cold.
I am not going to play Captain's Wisdom.
It's so cold at my...
Oh, wow.
Life has changed for us, gentlemen. Maybe things can happen that are good things, as long as an Aaron Ryder can happen to me.
All right, I am... I'm raising my threat by one so I can play this one card. But it's a good one.
I'm raising my threat by one.
When
it's my turn.
I think I'm going to go ahead elect not to plan anything.
All right. I played out of turn. I'm sorry.
Yeah. All I'm going to do is Elven Light and I'm passing plan.
Does Eleanor or Baragon want a resource?
Yes, then it's fine.
Using that.
Thanks.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Are you done playing, Chad?
I am. I played out of turn. I'm sorry.
Oh, all right. So I will, for one, Gondorian shield Eleanor.
Nice.
Yeah.
I mean, she's going to be canceling treacheries, but it's nice to have the option.
Nice to have the option.
Good, put it on board.
Now,
it's not a terrible idea.
That's fine. Woo! Then, I'll let you guys fight over this one.
Oh.
Give it to Sean, I think.
To who?
To who, though?
Galadriel, if he's got Nenya in the deck. Bearer of Ore, Conquest, and draw two cards.
Are you talking about Unexpected Courage at play?
Yeah.
Jeez,
Do you want Baragond?
I was thinking Baragond.
Yeah.
So then he can defend and lower some extra threat. I think that's... Much as I'd love to get in on one of my heroes, I think that's the better play.
I put Peregrine and Eowyn. So Eowyn will now be attacking Baragond, take Unexpected Courage.
Yep.
Yeah, I think
that's... So I think I have a faint and test of will. Let's get through this. Let's go.
I think we got to YOLO it here, boys.
YOLO! No, wait.
I'm YOLOing for 3.
7, 9. Nice, Dave.
Okay, 13.
I will YOLO only 6, so...
Sean, don't forget you're boosted a little bit.
And that you can send Aragorn via Exhaustion.
Oh, right. Okay, yep, so I'm at 11 then. Oh, no, and I have the sword that was broken going on, so right. I am 12, 13, 14, 15. Such a freaking good card.
A Klondike bar sounds amazing.
What was that, Jed?
Dark 293 is talking about Klondike bars, and now that's all I can think about.
Would you kill a man?
Now, Sean, I don't know this quest. How do we not thread out?
Being faster, mostly.
This
quest requires you to just rock from turn one. As does the next quest, it turns out. Pace is just a thing.
That makes sense, though. Here you go. Peril, Sean.
I'll let that happen, I suppose. So I lose 1, 2, 3, 4 willpower.
Okay, let's keep.
I need to be able to lower my threat. So.
Yep. Okay, card number 2. That is not the worst for me.
That's not the worst for me.
I can handle it.
It is doomed 1, which is terrible. The doomed one is way worse than the damage.
I would agree.
Yeah. Are we taking the hit, right?
Yeah, I lose this guy, though.
Yeah.
So I lose. That hurts.
Okay.
Oh, shit. I lose that guy, too. Boo. That card has hit me twice now. Oh, man. This is mine. Okay. Minus 1, 2, 3.
Won't Faramir kind of deal with that in terms of willpower?
Well, I mean...
Like, make it a wash, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I guess, but we're trying to win.
I know, but...
Well, peril, there's nothing to be done about it.
I know.
Screw you for not playing spirit, Chad.
Screw you, Sean, for keeping Gandalf around at the beginning of the game when we could have quested through on turn 2.
Was that actually a thing?
Yeah. We were worried about losing Gandalf, so then we couldn't cancel the one that actually stopped.
Yeah, I think yeah, trying to keep Gandalf alive for 2 of those treacheries was worse probably than...
I'm not hearing this anymore. I'm not hearing it, guys. I don't hear what you're saying. I'm going to reduce my threat by 4 with Merry.
Screw you.
Wow.
Okay, that he is. That's all right. Okay, let's see if we can still do it. 1, 2, 3, 4 plus 10 is 14, 18. 2 are 24.
Is there an action window during the engagement? So before the enemy engages?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Right, okay.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, 24 to 18 is 6 at the moment. 5, 6. Faramir. God, I'm not even a good... Am I a good candidate for Faramir anymore? I have 5.
I have 4.
Okay, I guess I still am.
Yep.
1, 2, 3.
So we still didn't make it out?
Oh, no.
How close are we?
Even... we need 10 more.
If you, so, oh, so God, so even if you farm it again, it wouldn't make a difference?
Nope. I lost like 10 threat this turn with those 2 treacheries. I would have been able to do it if those treacheries hadn't killed my guys.
All right.
Brutal. Brutal, brutal, brutal.
Very damn. Tough. Those haunted paths suck.
Yeah, but they're 5 threat and I mean
it's net neutral.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense to travel to them.
It gets 5 threat out of the staging area. It costs 4 points and a threat to go there. It's like it's a wash, so why not do it?
Yeah.
Unless it's going to threat anyone out this turn. That would be a good reason not to do it.
I'm close to
47. Let's go to a deadly road then.
No.
But then Dave is overcome by fear.
I say we don't travel.
You think we just don't quest over them? Okay.
Well, we don't want to. We can't spend the fellowship resource.
Mm-hmm.
And raising my threat puts me at 48.
I mean, oh, yeah, the thing I always discount is raising your threat actually increases the quest points on the quest. So, yeah, no, I think that's...
Wait. If we retcon one thing, we can go to Hidden Paths. Because I didn't need to do it. I haven't played anything for, like, 3 turns. If I Arwind Aragorn instead of Illidan, then we can travel.
That's fine. I think you can still do that after we travel there, and we don't even need to retcon.
No, because I can't... I've done. Oh, it's only once per turn, isn't it?
Well, right. Oh, I suppose that would be the retcon, is that you just haven't used Arwen's ability yet.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay, fair enough. That seems fine.
Then we go to a hidden path.
We'll travel to this one, right? Where it's a little easier to clear.
Alright.
Okay!
Before the action window before enemy engages.
Yeah. Dave, I don't know if you can see it, but you have a light sitting on the low half of the screen.
Huh?
Do you see that?
Yeah. That's so I don't have to go digging for it in the Discord pile.
Okay.
Revealed in Ref, the Shadow Host, so his text box is blank.
Great. Nice.
That does mean he's going to do damage, though, right?
That is true. He loses his Phantom keyword.
I'll take him for you, though,
if you're worried.
Yeah,
I've got Baragon twice.
Yeah, I think Baragon can do Baragon too. Sick, isn't he? He's got a shield.
I love Revealed in Wrath. I haven't had any good, like, crazy Revealed in Wrath moments yet, but I love the fact that that card exists.
Mm-hmm. Well, wait, it's only to the end of the phase, so we're just losing the...
Yeah, but engagement is the same as combat, right?
So you would do it during the encounter phase where he engages you, thus negating the extra attack.
All right, okay.
His damage would still come through as threat increase.
Right.
During combat.
Okay, that's fine. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But he's not going to hurt anybody. So
okay.
So I will engage. He doesn't make an immediate attack.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. So his immediate attack text is blank.
That's right.
And then now it's the combat phase.
Even if we lose this game, I'm happy because I got to use a full strength Tides of Fate and the Rebuilding Ref, so I don't care.
That you, you're the first person I've ever seen to actually pull off a full blast Tides of Fate. So, achievement unlocked.
Oh, no shadow.
Sweet.
Nice. So he's a 3. Ella Rahir will defend.
Nice.
Okay. Baragon obviously defends.
I think
stands back up.
Attacks back. We kill everything.
You reduce your threat, Daniel?
Yeah.
Oh no, you have your overcome by fear. Sorry.
I still have my overcome by fear. Everything's done. Eowyn and Baragon and Eleanor kill my dude.
Wow, we didn't even need to use Gandalf.
I feel like Gandalf wasn't even used this turn. Wow.
Overrated.
But, no, I need Gandalf.
Oh, to him, kill yours. Yeah.
Yeah, because I think I only hit for 7 out of the 8 I need.
Right.
Okay.
Thanks, Gandalf.
I can ready one more ally if it's useful to have any ally ready before the turn ends.
If I still had my wardens, it would have been. But as it stands, unless someone wants a resource.
I think you should shuttle a resource to Aragorn.
Oh, that seems all right.
Oh, that's a great idea. Okay.
Another round?
Shit. Yeah, good. Good deal.
Gandalf.
You can I just throw this? Okay, we're still keeping Gandalf on the table.
Yeah, I took the threat.
Okay.
Yeah, Aragorn.
I drew Gandalf, so that would have probably saved my.
Sean, did Barovord? She had quested, right?
Yeah, she quested. And for some reason, I haven't drawn my card. Or wait, did I? Right there.
Well, my deck is pretty much stalled because I can't raise my threat to play cards. So,
ooh. I'll raise mine.
But he can Galadriel you. You don't have your overcome by fear, right?
True. Dang. Yeah.
Who has Aragorn?
I've got Aragorn now.
Overhill, Underhill, Gandalf has done a ton of work for this quest, but it's also hurt. It's like I don't know how to feel about him right now. It's like,
why? I'm not the one with the highest threat.
I think he's done great work. And killing almost everything.
He has. No, I can't lead my Gandalf twice, and I wouldn't be.
Right.
Oh, I see. As the opportunity cost of playing core Gandalf.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because that's my only threat reduction. But let's see. If you Galadriel me, that buys me another turn, I could get.
Go.
I could get a lot of willpower on the table. Okay. So I will play. I'm just going to count it out. 1, 2, 3, 4.
I'm going to raise my threat by 1 to plan this turn.
6.
Okay. Did Chad play out of turn again?
Yep.
Sorry. Well, let's see. Would. Gondor or Noble? Would Sean or Daniel like the Envoy of Pelagir's resource on a Gondor or Noble Heroes resource pool?
Not going to do
that. No, I'm not planning.
Okay. Or Stokes?
No.
You don't want
you
want
to put it on Aragorn?
Okay, put it on Aragorn. That sounds good. I mean, I really don't need it.
Who's got control of Aragorn?
That seems solid. Is it me?
You moved him.
You did. You not? Okay, so it's me.
So I played the Rivendell Blade, discard an Elven Light to put a resource on. Have we got rid of all our Overcome by Fears now? Oh, no. Daniel's got his. Put a resource here.
Lemonheads is saying basically we missed an opportunity for me to have lowered my threat via Baragon.
By having him defend for you last round?
Were you?
No. He's saying if you had have blocked for Chad instead.
Yeah.
If I had engaged it.
Yeah, I see. Yeah, that's true.
That would have been a good move.
Guys, multiplayer is a world of should-haves. Let's not chase down those rabbit holes.
Got to remember Baragorn's ability. I haven't,
Baragorn?
Baragon. I haven't played with him enough.
Baragorn, Narnal, and Yenya, Anduril.
Defending.
We can't really engage. It's because it's too far away, and we wouldn't have killed the thing.
I think Gandalf could help me.
No.
Seven Miravor.
And the Warhorse. Ooh, Miravor.
And
ooh, Stokes, you're at 49?
Yeah, I'm going to buy back an Elven Light. Well, that was garbage. Pass planning.
Okay, I played out of turn again. I played three allies.
Okay. I am not raising my threat and will not plan.
Okay, I already raised my threat. Stokes, do you have any compelling allies in your hand?
I don't know about compelling, but I've got two.
Any that it would be worth getting into free? That sense not sense makes.
Not really.
Okay. So then I'm gonna spend two and toss down my man Ganbury Gan.
Yeah, you are.
Who?
Ganbury Gan. And we'll throw down a horse breeder. Let's see what we get here.
There's your allies.
I do think. Oh, wow. Look at all those not mounts. It's all right.
Did you whiff with the whifferer?
I'm pretty sure. I'm going to have to double check, but I'm pretty sure Shadowfax is the only mount in this deck.
And that's apart from the Hobbit pony that's on the table.
Oh, yes,
yeah, I get
and
your
Hobbit pony. Yep. That's why I had to check, Dave. That's why I had to check. I can't rely on, information that's in front of my face.
Yeah. I can see why you'd have trouble. Right, questing?
Yes.
All right, each character. So Aragorn is a 3, Arwen's a 4, so I'm in for 7.
You have sword that was broken.
Yep, and I'm going to Aragorn's cancel now. So in for 8.
Nice.
Okay, assuming I don't lose anybody.
Never assume that.
Oh, I know. God, this thing's been punching me in the dick.
And that's where they tend to aim.
Especially those hobbits.
Yeah, those hobbits. That's a straight punch. All right.
They need to someone needs to do a custom card that's called something like Dick Puncher Proudfoot or something.
I didn't see that. That makes me so proud.
All right, here we go.
Good.
Peril.
Who's Dave's?
Dope.
Fine. Reveal. This is mine. Mm-hmm. 2 willpower.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. Yep. My card. I'll take the attack.
I'll defend it so you can lower your threat.
Well, wait. Yeah, that works.
Yeah, right? That works. Yep. Defending player reduces.
Yes, Uragon.
Yay!
And it gets rid of that. Yes.
Oh my gosh.
Sean,
are you okay?
I don't know yet.
Okay, card number three. Oh, let's have this every time.
Is this mine?
Yep.
I obviously will take the additional encounter card.
Yeah, well, this is where you do your Isildur moment and doom us all.
Wait, hang on. I'm sorry, I skipped a step. I definitely lowered my threat when the Oathbreaker was revealed.
That's fine.
Sorry, I just didn't want to make too many beats before I realized that I missed a really good opportunity.
I could test if will this dude's when revealed and so we can keep going.
No, save it for way shot.
It's peril, so that's up to you.
Yeah, no, I will take an additional card.
Okay, that didn't work. There it goes. Aha!
That'll hit me for 2. That's fine. I'll lower my willpower by 2.
Okay. Card number 4. Oh my gosh. Golly. What we got here? 14, 16, 19, 21. I'm getting excited. 21, 2, 20,
36. Yeah.
So it's like 34. What did I say? 21?
Yep.
21 to
34
is
13. Yay!
Guys, we did it!
Yay!
All right, we're done.
Why is that if the players defeat this stage, they have won the game on that card in Sharpie?
Yeah. I wrote on it on my computer screen.
Yeah.
All right, here we go.
Oh my god.
Raise each player's threat by 10.
The worst. Yeah. Okay.
What?
No, you're good. Just go.
Oh, I'm not even reading the thing. All right, add the stone of Eric.
Wait, Chad. You
men
read the
and of horses and of pale banners like shreds of cloud, and spears like winter thickets in a misty night.
When did Legolas become Russian?
Was that Russian, comrade?
It sounds very Russian. Legolas should be fixing the space station in Russia.
The dead are following.
I want to beat America in the Olympics.
It's same moose and squirrel.
All right.
Moose and squirrel.
Okay. I added the Stone of Eric. I added the Army of the Dead. Stone of Eric reads, it's immune to player card effects. When it becomes the active location, we each search the encounter deck and discard pile for an Oathbreaker enemy. We add it to the staging area. And we remove 5 progress from stage 3B to travel. Army of the Dead. Phantom, immune to player card effects. X is twice the number of players in the game. Oh, good. That's 8. That's cool. when Army of the Dead attacks, you either need to discard.
Taking
or attach a thingy. Okay. We can each raise our threat by 3. I'm going to choose not to. To remove a overcome by fear, which currently would only be Daniel. I'm guessing no.
Yeah. Let's not do that. What's 3B?
Raise your threat by 10.
What else you got?
Yes. The dead
rise
behind.
Who's the phantom keyword? Ooh.
They have been summoned. Okay, Elladan, so, the king. While Stone of Eric is the active location, each Oathbreaker enemy loses the Phantom keyword and gets minus 20. When it leaves play, we win the game. We cannot travel to the Stone of Eric until we place 5 progress. So we got to do 2 rounds.
So it works in reverse order. First it goes on the quest, and then it goes on the location.
Yeah. Just like, what did I play recently that does the same thing? Mount Graham, right? That does that, right?
Right. I will gladly Well,
wait, okay. Travel.
Travel, you're right. Do we want to travel? I guess we could travel to a deadly road, but it's kind of a...
Deadly road.
Man, have we been doing the deadly roads effect? Take me
home. We haven't really catch anything for a couple of turns.
Anything for a long time.
Moose and squirrel.
We don't travel.
Stone of
Stop. Shush.
I will take the army of the dead.
Okay, I think we're going to not travel. That seems to be the consensus, right?
Yeah.
You're going to take the army of the dead? You have to get rid of an ally.
That's fine. Just chuck Sam.
Yeah, but...
I mean, yeah. That's how that works, I suppose. Eowyn's going to... She's really going to have her day.
Eowyn's going to hit him for 15. Yeah. Sorry. I need to... There, Gorn.
Kids, if you need information, ask your parents.
You can't trigger what?
He can't figure Eowyn's effect without threatening out.
Oh, yeah, but he can kill her at the end of the turn. He can kill her this turn and then leave.
Yeah, I will.
I mean, that is a thing. It's not a thing that anyone likes to talk about, but...
Yeah, can't even get... Is there no way to ready Galadriel? Oh no, this sucks.
Those do. So. Okay.
Is that what we want to do?
Well, I think personally, we won't kill it. Not everything else.
Wait, say it again?
I don't think we'll be able to kill the rest of the enemies and the army of the dead if you don't do it with Eowyn right this turn.
Right, I mean, it has to do it, I think.
Yeah.
I mean, we technically don't have to kill it.
Yeah, I mean...
Oh, right, we don't have to... We don't have to win. Right, okay.
It's a campaign.
Oh, right, okay. Oh, that's fine then. Yeah.
And why don't I have it in front of me, Baragond, over and over?
Yeah. That still makes more sense, yeah.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, get that thing the heck away from me.
Wait. No. Put it in front of a la Lemonhead. Put it in front of someone else.
Yeah, because then Baragon you can defend two other people. Yeah, and then they can lower their threat. God, you're so... Yeah, I think you're just constantly taking one for the team. I think you're overachieving, making the rest of us look bad.
Stokes, I think you should take it, since you don't have an ally. Or I can ditch an ally.
But then I have to sit overcome by fear, is the thing.
Chad, I think you should take.
There you go. I forgot about the ore. Okay. I will definitely
Take it. Why you? Because you don't have a chat overcome by fear anyway. It should be... No, because Sean's going to raise by two.
I have allies like...
I
get Sam back is when it attacks, not when...
Yeah.
Okay, so I have to engage that.
I'll take a Ghosts of Men.
Ghost of Men. There it is.
I'll take Faithless Dead.
I can take two.
Okay, and you can take two.
Yeah. I heard the Faithless Dead's newest album is great.
Oh my god. How many beers have you had?
I'm on my third pint. Why?
Oh, there you go.
It comes in pints?
We never could have told.
Hey, don't forget.
Please, I make high school band jokes in my soberest of states.
Right.
Don't forget Stokes and Daniel, you are minus one
to everything, yeah.
Yeah.
And Gandalf has things to do.
It is four.
I'll get rid of
these. I have to faint the dude in front of me.
Okay.
Because I can't defend him with Eleanor.
Yeah.
We must find Moose and Squirrel.
So
I kind
of
sound
right,
like
so, me. Defend one of mine.
Mm-hmm.
I have to defend the Army of the Dead.
Yeah, so one of mine and Army of the Dead, because that way me and Chad both get to defend our threat by... Oh no, it's only once per round. Blows. I thought it was once per player.
John
only has one more left on him.
Yeah. So do it on Chad. I'll defend mine. Right, so Elra here defends the first one.
Okay, yeah, I am one more threat than you. Okay, we don't have that clause anymore where we have to raise our threat at the beginning of the round. So
yeah,
that's true.
Okay, Baragon's defending.
No.
Me. So yeah, you're doing
that order again. Slap.
No. No, I was just asking, just making sure I understood what was going on. Okay,
who's defending? Ghost over here. I've paid the resource to rid him.
Oh, okay. He's defending both, so it doesn't really matter.
Yeah.
Nothing.
And then.
Nothing.
Just that one. Yeah. Okay.
Ooh, and Shadow Host goes away as a.
Yeah.
Nice. Con.
Okay, Baragon is defending this guy. Isn't he going to take damage though?
He will take. Yeah, I'll take one.
Oh wait.
No.
No, he's a six already. Oh no, he is a five.
He's a minus one, yeah.
But wait, he's a phantom, so technically.
It would be a threat, yeah.
He takes no damage.
Right. I would like him to take damage. Rather than threat.
Ooh.
But he won't take damage, so you can reduce threat. Or what happened?
I can't reduce threat because I'm overcome by fear.
Okay. So he's a 7 to Baragon.
And in player that reduces that threat.
Well, no.
It's only if Stone of Baragon Eric is the active is location, two, Dark 293.
But Baragon's going to take 2 damage, yeah?
One.
He's not taking any damage because if he takes no damage, which he's not going to take damage anyway, because he's even if he's on 5 defense.
Why is he not taking
Stone of Eric has to be the active location.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I thought we were defending the Army of the Dead. Sorry, my bad. I thought this dude was at 6 attack.
We are.
He is. Yeah. He still has the Phantom keyword unless Stone of Eric is
right.
The active location.
Right. Nope,
so it's
my bad.
Baragon's not taking damage.
I was seeing this shadow card under that enemy. That was.
You were seeing double?
By one.
Carry on, thieves.
So, okay,
I lose it by shadow. And back to the staging area, right?
Yeah, we kind of have to, otherwise we're threatened out, right?
Or I threat out.
Right, so we don't want to do that. You have to raise your... Who raises their threat? You do, right?
Oh, it was defending player.
Defending player. So I think you actually...
Oh, that's how Phantom works? Defending player, not character? Okay, that makes sense.
Oh! No.
Instead of damage, threat. So actually, I take it, right?
Yeah, you take the threat from that, which is one.
And then I actually lower my threat because Baragon did not take damage.
Yeah.
I would agree.
And then the shadow card kicks in.
And I put him up in the staging area.
Right, okay.
Okay. Man, confusing.
Now it's attack backs, right?
Yeah.
Guys, give Gandalf something to do.
No.
I don't need him.
No, actually. Yeah, keep that resource. Rohan Warhorse readies. Him and Aragorn kill Ghosts of Men. Pay one, and then I'll kill...
I don't need you.
All right.
I have Eowyn and do it. So save your resource.
Eowyn and.
And Harrowgrim.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
She hits for 5.
Got it.
Fuck. God, do I even raise my threat to keep Gandalf around anymore?
Oh my god, if you didn't use him this round and I could have played this.
But if I discard him, you can play it next round.
Yeah, because he does. If he, you know, he uses the quest. Oh. Yeah.
You might draw.
He wouldn't have met him before.
That's okay. It's all right.
We got this.
Well, Gandalf did this. Gandalf did do all right, so
yeah.
That was something.
It's up to you, Sean. What are you gonna do?
Are you like gone if you don't draw a Gandalf?
Oh no, I got I got three threat to play with, and I can play cards without raising my threat. So,
okay.
Well, I'll, we're fine for a little bit.
I'll keep him then until I know it would benefit someone for him to go away.
Yeah.
I mean, what would suck and what's going to happen, because of course it will, is I'm going to draw my third copy of Gandalf this turn.
All and right, Sean, I'm sure I have
to react to you.
Right. So. Okay, what do we got to do? We got to put 5 progress on and then deal with another round of combat. Mm-hmm. And then, put 5 progress on, then travel, then deal with a combat, which is like guaranteed to bring out 4 enemies. So Gandalf should have something to do this turn.
Yeah.
What is getting the Army of the Dead do for us as an objective ally?
In nothing? The campaign mode.
Nothing. Doesn't do anything in this. Yeah.
This it does nothing, mode, right? Yes. It turns into a boon for later, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. So.
Be around?
Yep. Yeah. I'm just grabbing Aragorn. Okay, Gandalf staying?
Oh, God. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Here we go. Okay.
That's Did you it. Draw another one, Chad?
That's not it. That's not it. All right.
Nice.
You made the right call.
All right.
I thought for sure we were going to get screwed. Actually, I got something that's amazing.
Why won't my things increase?
This time. So I was even going to wait.
You know what sucks most about this quest is that every one of those treacheries is peril.
Yep.
It's pretty intense.
Like, Eleanor can't do stuff, and the test of wills don't really matter. Ugh.
Well, actually, it's kind of interesting, because from a design perspective, I respect what peril does to actually balance a test of will. But at the same time...
No, I dig it. I do.
At the same time, as a player, I'm like...
I'm being funny. I really don't think the fact that there's now, 2 cards that counter encounter cards... And, you know, for the most part, the easiest one to use is Tested Will. I don't think it needed to be cancelled. Countered.
With Peril?
It's not like...
I don't think it needs it. It's like, if everyone's playing Spirit, then yeah, it's an issue. And everyone's running 3 copies, yeah, it's an issue. But it's not... Yeah, I mean, it's less like... That's like patching something for the worst case scenario, or the best case scenario.
Right.
C-Stan's going to make the video to refute that, but I don't have it within me to.
But but that's what he does.
I'm pretty sure last week on Discord he said Daniel. He was talking about just a maximize cancel treacheries deck. So we'll see
you,
what comes
but
out
you,
of that.
You, of course you can do it, but that's what I'm saying is that you know, if every sphere had at least one form, I mean, Law's got it now, it requires some setup, or some form of encounter cancellation, even if tactics is like cancel an enemy, and I guess you can kind of say Revealed in Wrath is kind of that, but it doesn't need to be countered.
And Lemonhead makes a great point on the chat, like the thematic sense of the peril here and sort of individually these people being...
They sure. can suck a dick.
My goodness.
Dave, I don't know who you are anymore. Sometimes I think you're a theme player, sometimes I think you're a power player, and I never know when I'm right.
I only said that just because you know it's me, that's why.
Uh-huh. Yes. Everyone needs
Okay. I am done. I'm gonna be able to quest for a lot.
Sean, between does Barovor need
visionary leadership and Faramir? I should be able to quest for a ton.
Sean, did you hear me?
Nope. Something about Barovor.
Yeah, does she need to quest, or can you give me cards just in case I can get... Well, maybe I don't need more Test of Wills, since I can't use them really anyway.
I can give anyone 2 cards. I don't think...
I know, but the problem I have with...
Gonna do anything right now.
Big foam with Daniel Gare. Shut up, James. If the doomed one treachery comes up, then it's out with those cards that he draws.
Why would I throw it out with those cards I draw?
Because you're on 48 now. Bear of Oil gives you 2 cards. Doomed one comes in the encounter phase. End of the turn, you're gone.
Crickets? Crickets?
How did crickets? Or give me... I don't understand.
That's assuming you can't play them.
Yeah.
Hey, Stone. Let me ask you. I'm going to heal just a second. I'm going to heal Arwen and Denethor?
Mary? Oh, yeah, Denethor.
Don't worry about Mary. He's got his hobbit pony now.
Yeah.
Okay. Whoopsie. Wrong button. Continue your thingy.
Dave or Sean, do you guys need a song of travel for any resource smoothing?
No, thank you.
Will not affect me at the moment.
Okay.
I also don't need one. Thanks for asking.
Why would you need a song of travel?
I'm just saying it would have been polite.
What?
You know what? For one, I'm putting song of travel on Denethor.
Put it on Aragorn if you're going to put it on somebody. He travels.
No.
Got him up.
You were rude.
Stop it.
Stop it.
Dave, again, why Barovor giving me two more cards is bad.
I'm just saying, if you can't play them, then
you
potentially, if the Doomed One treachery comes up during encounter phase, you're gone this turn with the two cards that somebody else could have drawn, is what I'm saying.
Right. I do have a lot of reasons.
Oh, yeah, I appreciate that. But like holding it for a test of will when the Doomed One is still going to go off isn't.
Right.
You know, Denethor getting the spirit icon could ready Sam. I'm just saying.
Back in your box, you. You two hang around with Brandon far too much.
I hung out with him a lot lately.
Yeah, no
he
shit.
He rubbed off.
Oh, no one wants to see those pictures.
I thought to Denethor. I want it back on him.
All right.
All right, so where are we? I've lost the will to live.
I'm still trying to figure out if I want Barovor's cards.
Daniel's still pining right for now. Cards.
Sean, can I have him?
Yeah, I guess I don't see why not.
Promise not to threat out.
To be fair, this time I'm going to piss my pants.
Oh, all look right. At this. It's actually pretty good.
Who else kills people?
That's Rohan or Tactics, you probably should say.
That's Rohan Tactics.
No.
I would elect for no one other than Eowyn, potentially.
Eowyn?
If she's
who already has her two restricted cards.
Yep.
Alright. Well then for two spirit, I'm gonna bring out two horse whifferers. And I will do their thing. Hold on a sec. Is he leaving?
Yep.
Is who leaving? Oh, I thought you meant
one ran away.
I thought you meant like fucking Stokes. I'm like, what? What's happening?
That's it. I'm leaving.
He can't take it anymore.
All right, so this is going in my hand for one whiffer.
Oh.
That could help you guys after I die. That, I'm going to look.
Oh, I could actually.
Yeah, so that's going to be good. Look at.
That would be great.
Top 10 again.
I have it. I want
and
it. It's mine. My precious.
This time my horse whiffer truly whiffed.
Pardon.
Way of saying.
All right. Who wants to steed it?
I'm just gonna take this and.
All right. Great.
Yeah.
I technically have to pay for it and play it, so there you go.
True.
I
with one of my three spirit resources.
Axe is my hand. So
I know, I'm just joking. But if you want a resource, do you need a resource back?
I have the one I need for Test of Will. So, okay. Nope.
All right.
I'm done.
That was good.
Sean?
That was good. That card basically gave me 4 willpower.
Someone wake the drunkard in the corner.
Not. Okay, I'm slightly drunk, but it's okay.
But you're not in the corner.
No, I'm definitely not in the corner. Right.
Nobody put Sean in the corner.
I mean, we're... Sean, I'm not planning. I passed.
Do you want to play your Imladris caregiver? I can pass you a resource.
Can you?
Yeah.
Oh, Aaron Riders.
Yeah.
I mean, sure. Yeah, I won't say no to that.
There you go.
Puts a progress on Berevort.
What the hell is happening?
He says he does right after he says he's not drunk.
Please. That happens in my soberest of soberest states.
Yeah.
You did just say soberest of sobery, which
you didn't even say it right, Chad. Don't.
That's right. I can't even say it.
I'm gonna discard actually I think I did that already. Yeah, I did. And we will put a... Miravore on. Where's the other Miravore I put down? Oh, I've got... Yes, on these two.
Miravore. The twins are getting drunk tonight, too.
Yeah. Should get a Sean. And I will discard Elven Mal... and Elven Light to past planning.
Okay, boys.
Questy.
Oh, man. We're close.
Oh, no, we don't have an active location. That's so sad for me.
Are we questing?
Yep.
You're right. Laughing at me, Dave. That just seems cruel.
You've met me, right?
It wasn't my choice to not travel anywhere last round. Gonbury Gon could be questing for 5 right now.
Yeah. Well, not really, because we couldn't travel there. But his, yeah, I see your point.
Look at his little cute face, though. He's like a pug. He's so ugly, he's cute.
It's like his hands are coming out the top of his head.
No, those are antlers that are tied into braids on his hair, obviously.
Well, why? They shouldn't have drawn it to look like a wooden hand.
They're antlers. It kind of looks like wood in a way.
It looks like a wooden hand.
I mean, all right. Yeah, I guess he's in the sunset or something.
It's a wooden hand. He's got his sex doll behind him, and it's caressing his face.
He's secretly Jaime Lannister with his golden hand, by the way.
So,
wait for Chad to calculate his will. Chad's willpower is 31.
Right? Wait, I forgot Aragorn's 34.
Shut up. Yeah. Where was this 5 bloody turns ago?
When I lost all my allies, and then I lost all my allies again. And Aragorn helps a lot.
You should plan for that.
I did. The allies I lost were the Wardens of Healing.
Right, okay.
So
this is pre-Faramir, guys.
Yeah.
So...
Pre-farm there's 20, what?
27 in the staging area.
Brewer Dan Forrest. Nice. Nice. Where was that on Twitter?
What happened?
Okay. Oh, he just made an awesome pun. Okay.
I don't know about awesome. It's James.
Oh. Fucking wow. Savage.
Welcome to the COTR roast.
Okay, this was mine. This is good because I don't have Test of Wills. Oh!
Give me some peril.
Yes!
You got it.
All right.
Cancel.
When revealed, either attach, set aside, over, yada. What are you saying?
Test of will.
Deals with Surge. I will. I think I'm going to test a will that.
Good choice.
Oh.
Okay.
Good. Out your little cough, Jack. All right.
There we go.
Good.
Oh, we're going to have a Damn lot it. Of enemies coming. Okay. Sean, your card, buddy.
I'm okay with that, actually, right now.
Discarding an ally? Yeah, that's no problem.
I lose one.
That drops me down by two.
Why didn't you kill Gonbury Gon? No, I'm just kidding.
Stokes, what are you going to do?
I pitched an Elvajula. I just put into play.
Thank God.
Just look at that cute little face. I could touch a good burger.
You could burger? What?
Sean's turned into Gizmo from Gremlins.
Yeah. Beach old.
Is this Stokes' turn? Okay.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
No! Stop, game. That's no fun.
Okay. Now, this is not Carol. Okay, but
I will,
there are far, 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 far worse things.
I'll live through this. I'll only lose one willpower.
Stokes has to take
it. I'll take it. I've still got one turn after this, then.
Okay. I will
you sure?
lose
yeah.
another. Oops.
Take an overcome by fear.
For this. Losing those guys. Okay.
All right.
Okay, you grabbed it. Okay, I think we did it. Let's see if I need to Faramir or not, because we're going to have a lot of enemies come out. I will add our willpower. Someone adds the threat.
I'll add the threat. So it was 27 plus 4.
In their 31. Head.
I thought you just did it.
Oh.
6, 7, 9.
6, 7, 9.
So
it's 31.
All right. I think we have
30, and the threat on its own is 31.
48. We got
wow.
It. Okay.
Chad, I have a question to ask you.
Yeah.
So remember how you forced me to give you Gondorian Shield to Boromir? Have you used it?
You gave it to me last round.
No, it was a couple
of enemy.
Have you defended anybody with him?
No.
I don't think so.
Dave answers.
No. Wait.
Now I'm just super angry.
Why? Oh, because you wouldn't have had to raise your threat?
Yeah. Well, it doesn't matter.
No, it's
limitless. I'm not angry.
Wait, I think I did, didn't I?
No, you haven't.
You're right, I didn't. I totally didn't. I didn't really
in
willpower there.
I want new Boromir.
Hmm?
What's Boromir done this? Who is he?
He's provided a massive attack boost. Then Chad doesn't really do any attacking. What is Boromir doing?
Well, normally he does attacking, but he's basically wearing visionary leadership.
Yeah, he's basically just a dude in a dress at this point.
He actually has not been doing much, which is surprising,
because
normally he does a ton
of
work. I
think in most decks, Imrahil is better. Just going to throw that out there.
We've got extra action. We're not half his allies with him. What?
Actually, you know what? You know what he's been doing? To be completely honest, he has been killing a lot of things, is what he's been doing.
Yeah, he has. That's fair.
All right, so we're going to Stone of Eric, which is funny. That's usually not what he does, but he has been providing.
Which
so Emerald I don't know.
Could do equally as well.
I know.
All right, so after this happens,
everyone gets an enemy. We want the when revealed ones, please. Ads, yes, but we don't want any ones with the engaged.
Okay, let's look at the 12 cards that are left to see what kind of shadows we're going to get. Okay, there's only half of them have shadows. Let's see, plus one. There's two, there's three of the defending character cannot ready.
Yay!
And those are not enemies. I'm looking. The enemies that are in the encounter deck are...
Well, if those treacheries are in there, we don't want to thin that out.
We want everything from the discard pile.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm seeing here. I think that I agree, because only one enemy has a when revealed, and it's not even that bad. It's just add to the threat dial thingy, or it makes an attack. So we are going to leave that be.
What's going to happen is we're going to go from...
Okay, you want me to read the treacheries we got are the minus one to all your threat, all your stats, and then three copies of the... Oh my god.
Yeah.
No.
It's the doomed one, isn't it?
Of the doomed ones.
Yeah. Don't thin the encounter deck.
Or do I pull all four enemies out and get six shadow cards and get rid of them all?
Oh shit, that's a good idea.
Yeah, if that's how many is left, then do that.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. So I have a question about Eowyn's thing. Is if I trigger her once a game ability, do I threat out before she attacks?
Yeah.
Yes. I think the rulebook says as soon as your threat dial.
Yep.
It's immediate? It's not at the end of something? Okay.
Nope.
No, I think the game state constantly checks your threat dial.
Damn.
Would my ability to Galadriel you make a difference?
No.
No, I'm still overcome by fear.
Oh, God. I hate that card.
That's going away.
It gets so much harder in multiplayer.
It's not going to go away before he loses, before he raises his threat by one, though.
Oh. At the end of the round.
He's gone this turn.
I think this is it for me.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a shame. Well, it is one less card we have to reveal.
My God.
Thanks for your Gondorian shield and war horse and Steed of the Mark and Song of Travel.
Bye, Felicia.
Poor Daniel.
Oh, all right.
Boo.
Let's do this.
Let's do this. Oh, you're cutting out, buddy.
Optional engagement?
Yeah, I'm first, so I will take... What's this guy do? Either put it on my threat dial or it makes an immediate attack. I can handle an immediate attack.
Was there not any better targets than him?
Those are the four that were in the...
Oh, right, yeah, okay.
I can throw them back in if you want, but...
Chad, why don't you take the Army of the Dead and Baragon can defend it? And he'll just go back up to the staging area. You'll get your threat reduced, probably.
I feel like that's risky, because that's 6 against 6. I'm going to get another enemy. I might ask you to defend a different one.
Okay.
I don't know yet. And
I have two defense. I have two defenses with him.
I got three defenses on over here.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll take. All right, I'll take a dead man of Dunharrow for Eleanor to defend.
Boop. Sean, you're gonna pass.
Sean,
I can pretty much take whatever.
Okay, which one do you want?
So I think the elephant in the room is the Shadow Host, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bear in mind that now they don't have the Phantom keyword.
Okay. Yeah, I'll engage the Shadow Host.
Good man, Sean. Good man.
I'll take a Ghost of Men.
Ghost of Men, okay, and then...
These
are all minus 20, so...
I think I go ahead and take the additional attack on the Shadow Host when it engages me.
Oh, okay, yep, you're right. My apologies.
You want me to defend that?
I was thinking about just letting Gon go, but next time he's questing for 4, so maybe not. No, he's questing for 5. Wow. I'll just defend it.
Okay.
Crap. Yep. Okay.
That's a bounce.
Dink. Right, so now shadows to everything else. Starting with Chad.
So all these cats are hitting for
real damage actual now. Yeah.
All right. Great.
Okay. And then
really, keep in mind, everyone, that we don't need to be able to kill these enemies. We need to be able to quest through the location next round, and that's how we win.
Yep, and we just emptied the deck, so...
But, if it's going to reshuffle at the start of the quest phase, if we get more enemies in the discard pile, there's less chance of us dooming out from the treacheries.
Also true.
The best balance. Oh, I don't think any of the shadows did in addition.
The middle
I wish
way.
An additional attack was one of these shadows. Yep.
The third.
If an additional attack was one of these shadows, then all these dooms would have went into the discard pile. Dang.
Right. Okay. Let's just get this over with.
There's a chance for this. There's a chance for you all. All right.
we'll moan you. Don't worry.
Yeah, I just want
I'm gonna defend.
Sung by Shun about my departure. That's all.
Okay. We can do that. I'll defend with Boromir.
Thanks.
In his current state, he is going to sound like a Teletubby song, though. You realize this?
That's fine. Bard is a bard.
Bard is a bard, yeah.
I never understood the bad rap that Tinky Winky got, personally.
Wow.
Okay. Let's talk for a second about who's going to get their threat reduced from Galadriel and who's going to get their threat reduced from Barragon. Big Foam Loaf, why don't you defend your own guy and lower your threat?
Because.
I can't.
Oh, God. Okay, that's a really good reason. Okay.
That card gets so much worse in four player than it does in any other player count.
Yeah.
It's kind of bad.
Okay. Sean.
Yeah, man.
Yes.
Wait forever to
you
clear it.
You and I are the only two who can lower our threat. So are you planning to do Galadriel and I'm hoping to get a Barragon?
That's, I guess, up for debate. I have Merry as an option next round, so I'm not terribly worried about how, like, I'm going to survive, so I don't mind throwing my Galadriel to someone else.
I'm the only one who could take it, which, you know, I'm not going
to
complain about.
So here's something to think about in terms of my defense.
Mm-hmm.
If Sean can somehow Narya up like Sam and a horse whifferer, my Barragon can sentinel for everybody. Yeah. And so, Sean, if you were able to like...
I can defend for Sean.
Have you already used Shadowfax?
Yeah, yes.
Yeah, so if you could just get rid of, or Narya rather, one horse whifferer and yourself back up, that would be great. And then Barragon can defend for two people. Eleanor will defend one of my dudes, and then I'll feed a whifferer to somebody. So if you sentinel...
God. Sorry, I was struggling to follow because I keep forgetting that everyone doesn't have Phantom Trait right now. Okay, so yeah, that totally makes sense. Yep, I'm fine with that.
Right.
So I'll ready Breeder, and you said you only needed one, so Gandalf can come back up.
Yeah. Then you can, and then so I can spend my time defending for Chad.
Right.
Yep.
Right.
So I definitely want Barragon to defend against
first.
Okay, against the wimpy guy, against the dead men of Dunbar.
Okay.
Because I want him to take no damage. Okay, beautiful.
Great. And then he's back up.
If you want to defend six against six.
Yeah, that's great.
Because Aragorn has Sentinel as well. If you throw a...
Oh,
okay.
That's too bad.
That worked out.
Barragon can't ready when he's dead.
Yeah.
He's not dead.
But he'll threat out.
Dead.
Yeah. But technically, you fret out before the check at the end of the round anyway, so...
I think I'll go for a walk. All right.
That's comforting.
Dave,
all right.
Saying what...
Thank you very much.
Thinking.
Daniel?
What?
Your defense.
Oh, yeah.
Defend with Overcome by Fear. It's got Gimli on it.
Oh, yeah. Good idea. plus one, so it's a three attack.
He's a two defense though.
You know, he's a three defense in Narnia. Oh no, you didn't do the plus one spirit resource already.
No.
So he's dead, I believe.
No, he's just one damage.
One damage. He's got two hits.
And then Eleanor will defend the other.
Okay.
Boom.
That's a bounce.
Okay.
Sean, do you want me to defend for you, and then you've got more attack power with range to throw around?
Sure. I won't say no to that.
Okay, Shadow Host.
Shadow Host.
Oh, boo.
It's a good thing you do it right, Stokes, where you ready them before you reveal it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You're going
to... I can Sentinel...
Yeah. What is that? Yeah, do that.
Or Gandalf could.
Yeah, but you kind of want to kill some stuff as well.
They have Gunbury.
Yeah, we could chuck Gunbury Gun on the bus.
But he might not die.
Yeah, that's also true.
Oh, yeah, no, I'm totally fine with that. Let him defend.
Okay.
Yes!
Hey, nice. Very nice.
To quest for five next turn.
Do you want me to defend for you, Dave, so you don't have to exhaust him and not
run? Yeah. Yeah, please.
Okay. What's that?
Defending character does not ready.
Oh, fudge.
That doesn't matter.
Ready anyway.
Huh?
He wouldn't ready anyway, would he?
Yeah, he would.
Not going to ready at the start of the next turn.
Oh. Man.
Yeah, last through the refresh phase, so.
We still got this. You got loads of allies. Yeah. It's gonna pass to Sean, so that's not your problem.
Yeah, I know. It's just a bummer. All right. Our attack backs, starting with me. I can swing right now for 1, 2, 5. So I'm going to shuffle.
Wait a minute. Don't I live after this?
No. One threat from this and one threat for the end of the turn.
Can I get rid of Overcome by Fear before it?
No, nope, because it says after. Raise your threat by one and then spend. I don't think you even get the chance to spend because you get the plus one threat at the beginning of the refresh phase for the end of the turn.
That is my interpretation as well, sadly.
Yeah, when we hit Control R, you'll raise your threat by one and then you go to the end of the phase where you'll raise it again.
This game was created by really evil people.
Wait, we lose, don't we?
Why?
Oh, because then because
Aragorn's going to leave play. We've actually lost. Is that actually what's going to happen? Because I'm about to flip my desk.
I think that's accurate.
No. Because I die before I'm the first player.
No, but he moves. He moves at the beginning of the refresh phase. Where's Pocket Rafe?
No.
What's the text? Because I text on him. What is the text on Aragorn?
If Aragorn leaves play, the players lose the game.
That's it?
The first player gains control of Aragorn.
So you become first player at the beginning of the refresh phase. Aragorn moves to you. Your threat goes up by one at the beginning of the refresh phase. At the end of the turn, you gain one threat from Overcome by Fear. You hit 50 threat and threat out. All of your cards leave play.
Yep.
Well.
No.
We're going to win.
Seems like such a terrible way to lose.
That's the worst fucking way to lose after a game?
Oh, no, I refuse for this to happen. So... Here's how it's not going to happen. Is it attack time?
Yeah.
I don't know what the time is anymore. Someone. Yeah, it's attack time.
It's beer number four time for sure, I think.
I'm jumping on rules.
No, don't, Chad. They're right. I'm just going to have Eowyn trigger her ability.
Yes, do that.
Yeah, kill yourself before you change.
Kill yourself.
Oh my God.
I'll help.
Yes.
I'll help you. You're useless. You're horrible. You should kill yourself. Why are you even on this earth? What's your even reason for getting up in the morning?
That's
you
a
worthless
really
piece of...
Chad, the allegory is creeping me out.
Oh, now, sorry. Chad, you want...
I was quoting science.
But I understand what you're saying. So is there someone that I can, is there something I can, I can't do anything right now anyway. I can't attack anyone ranged.
You can trigger her action.
This is so funny. The way we're going to win the game is by you.
No, he can't. Isn't this the thing with Tactics Eowyn? She's not ready, so she can't activate a thing.
No, but she can still attack and then ready before it resolves.
Yeah, attack one of your enemies. Thank God you have
two. Oh, right. Yeah.
The only way this wouldn't have worked is if you didn't have two enemies. Yeah. That would have been bad.
And it would have been, then it would have failed. Yeah.
This is really one of the funniest plays I've ever seen.
We're absolutely fine. All right.
Yeah, go for it. This is crazy. I love this.
But Chad is you.
I'm done.
Is your attack action?
I did. I killed one of my guys. That's all I can do.
Okay. I will have Eowyn attack a dead man of Dunharrow with Heragrim and kill it.
Kidoki?
And then she will raise her threat to ready. Oh no!
Wow. So, this guy goes back to stage in.
Mm-hmm. You know, to me it's funny because I didn't even think about it because like the thought of doing this never crossed my mind. Like, oh, well, just kill yourself first.
What, what a weird way for Eowyn to maybe save the game.
Yeah.
Oh, you're the MVP for sure with this move.
Yeah.
This is the MVP play of the game right here.
Are you, wait, refuse for the Eowyn bard song to be Creed or whoever that is?
You refuse.
You wealth me.
I'm free. Okay, Sean, what are you doing?
What am I doing? Am I saving this attack for someone else, or am I trying to kill my own stuff?
Kill.
Yeah, chairman. Pow.
Hold on. Yeah, kill your own stuff.
Okay.
Because I can kill mine.
Kill a dead man.
He was the only one that could have killed himself, too. That's what makes this so funny.
I'll kill my ghosts of men.
Anyone else would have been screwed.
Ready Eladan, and then Eladan will put, it doesn't really matter, put 3 damage there.
Okay. Wow. That's insane. I'm still kind of geeking out over that move.
Yeah. It's right, new turn?
Oh my gosh, that's so funny. Galadriel.
Yeah, who wants it?
It's got to be Chad or you. I can't do it, take it because I've got overcome by fear.
Go ahead, Sean. You got one more threat than me.
Okay.
And I would lose the card anyway, so.
Yes, that too.
Oh my gosh. You're still here, right, Daniel?
No!
He didn't leave, did he?
Ah!
No, he's here. He's probably all right. Taking a...
Okay.
Or something. Like, oh, thank God, now I can.
Who's this finished? I'm going to piss like a racehorse.
Exactly.
Yeah, I might work on that before we're finished.
What happened? I left for a second.
You thought you'd left.
Yeah, we were just glad you're still here.
We thought you'd mic dropped.
Yeah.
Oh. No, that was the right thing to do, but I didn't.
Oh my gosh. I'm just geeking out over it. I love it. Love it, love it, love it. Okay, Aragorn is... Oops.
Why are my things not thinging?
Like that.
Pocket Wraith made it seem like I didn't have to do what I did, but I'm glad I did it.
I'm pretty sure you were dead.
I'm sure I've seen a ruling somewhere about what happens when the person with the objective hero threats out, but I can't remember for the life of me what it says. Sure, I've seen something, but it might have been recently as well. Why are you looking? Daniel could look. He's got nothing else to do.
Yeah, of course that's why I'm looking. I'm thinking about my planning phase.
Guys, this is how ghosts are created.
Yeah.
Right. The spirit is questioning whether or not its sacrifice or departure from the earth was justified.
Can you stop getting existential and do your planning phase?
Impossible. I suppose I could try this and draw 2 cards. Which allows me then to throw down a ninja.
I would like to say thank you to Chairman Pow.
Yeah.
I'm assuming Eowyn's death is the big play you're talking about.
Definitely was.
Well, it really snatched freaking defeat from the jaws of victory, or vice versa. I can't even remember.
No, it snatched victory from the jaws of victory, which was actually defeat.
Okay. Yeah. Let's go with that. It's 4:30 here. I can't really concentrate.
I'm super done planning.
I'm going to play down a Trollshaw Scout. Buy back an Elven Light. Draw a card. And then do it again. Well, that was worthless. I'm done.
I imagine Pocket Wraith is that first player just changes the minute I die. And Aragorn goes to would have gone to Sean, right? So.
Guys, I'll be right back.
God. From the toilet, we don't get to finish this quest.
That's true. he already committed characters. Is there anybody that needs healing?
Needs? Not really.
I commit them to the quest? All right, I'll commit them to the quest.
If you can offer belated threat reduction, I'll take it.
Nobody. Sean's in the restroom. All right, I'm going to see if I can find this.
Yeah, what happens if the first player threats out? That's essentially it, right?
Yeah. I'm sure I've read it somewhere.
I know, me too, buddy.
I hope we don't find a rule that kind of makes my whole heroic gesture pointless.
Oh, no, no. Everything you did is correct. There's no way. There's no way.
It was about Aaron. I only did that so Aragorn didn't.
Well, even if Aragorn wouldn't die, you killed an enemy, which would have got we would have had two enemies in the staging area to quest over, which is not really a big deal with Chad's stupidly huge willpower, but
right
might make the difference. Still, we still have to make 5 progress.
Right, I think you guys are going to do it.
Yeah.
Although there's no campaign for any.
I don't have any chests of wheels.
We got doomed ones to worry about, and the stupid camp.
You know what's going to happen after all this is that Sean is going to be the only one that survives.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Dave, do you have another Noldor card?
No.
I cannot find this anywhere. That's crazy to me. Oh well.
Does that make him cry?
I'm so. Oh. I was going to say, I'm so glad you cut them, but then it finally caught up and I got the rest of it. Yeah, question?
Yep.
I'm in for 5. I'll keep Elra here back just in case we need to defend.
Okay. I'm in for 12, and I have Nenya and a Hobbit pony yet to trigger.
Wait, Stokes, why would you leave him back to defend?
Because if we get one of those attacks during revealed or whatever.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm sending 25.
Wow.
All right, well.
I don't think it's mathematically possible for us to surge train into more than that, but.
I'm more worried about doomed ones and cannot place progress on quest.
Well, there are 3 still doomed ones knocking around, aren't there?
Mm-hmm. Well, reshuffle.
Right, so this is where we draw 3 doomed ones, reshuffle. And this is it. This is when.
Aragorn.
This is when Sean drunkenly drives to Caleb's house and punches him in the dick.
Aragorn's exhausted, buddy. He didn't ready.
Oh no! Did that Sean? Not happen? What happened? Why didn't Aragorn ready?
Because
he's exhausted from yep. last round.
The shadow character thing.
Okay, fine.
Okay, here we go.
Do you add all of your plus ones for...
No, I had not calculated that yet.
Okay. Well, that's a moot point.
Who's it going to? It's going to... Yeah, it just cancels all your plus ones.
That's me?
Yep. That's all right.
Well, fair enough. No, unless he takes care of
my fit. That's more willpower then. We only have to do...
Yeah. Give me an overcome by fear.
You got it, buddy.
That was power, but fuck it. It's 430.
No. I'm totally with you.
Okay, Dave. Oh, no!
Dave is gone.
I'm out! Wait, I was on 48! No, I wasn't. Shit. Bye, guys.
Oh no.
Thank you, the questioner.
And this is dealing damage. Uh-oh. Oh my god, I'm losing a lot.
Damn it.
Fuck.
I'm gone. So I'm at 7. Ugh.
God, no way. It's going to happen again. It's going to happen again. The third one. But there's only three encounter cards, and the third one's going to be another one of those.
Okay,
blood runs chill. Oh God, blood runs chill. Blood runs chill.
Oh, Dave, you know what? No cheering for the encounter deck at this point, you bitter bastard.
Dave, you dork. I thought you were chanting for something
good. No. I know the game. You can all fucking suffer now.
Here we go. You ready, Sean?
No.
Yes! Okay.
Alright.
Okay.
So, 10, 14, 16, 18.
Wait. No. Those are a lot less now.
Oh, yeah! So...
That's 10 total between those locations.
14.
14.
Your threat doesn't go down, Sean, because you've gotten overcome by fear.
When
oh, you ninjured. Yeah, I thought you were marrying to lower your threat.
Nope. Okay. I hobbit ponied and ninjured for an extra 6 willpower.
Okay, Sean basically covers the staging area minus 1, so here's that, which puts 15 from me.
Yep. Well done.
Yeah, boys. God. I mean, if we were playing this in campaign, that would have been a shit show, but...
That would have been awful.
In one-off, 2 out of 4 is not half bad.
Oh my god.
Woo.
Wow.
Probably one of the best games I've ever played, like, being a part of.
That was a really good game.
That was
now, here's
a hell of a game.
Rules question. Oh. As soon as Dave threaded out, did you have to do another card?
Yeah, the determination of how many cards you reveal is made at the beginning of the encounter phase. So,
well, that's a shame.
Wait, what do you mean?
Or sorry, beginning of the quest phase, the staging step. So, if someone is like, say your last damage is on a character that's exhausted, and then something does a damage to all exhausted characters. Someone's still going to reveal an additional card during that questing phase because they're three at the beginning of it.
That was awesome!
But yeah,
that was a really
GG,
good game.
Boys. That was a really, really good game. I don't think...
Because we dug ourselves out of a hole at least twice.
Yeah.
Like out of a huge hole.
We had a couple of pretty big deficits a few times.
Yeah.
I agree with, I guess, Chris Jackson. I'm amazed.
Pocket Rain, I'm pretty sure you were going to throw out like an hour ago.
I am just so glad that my decision to go first, or rather my anti-decision because I didn't actually decide it, my decision to go first didn't kill me because holy cow, Mary was able to make up for the deficit that Gandalf created.
Considering there was so much plus threat in this quest, the fact that you managed to hold on to Gandalf the entire game. That was only 8 turns. Oh my god. Right. I can't be right.
That's still pretty remarkable.
It must be 9. It must be 9 because Sean would have been at his third go, right, as first player.
But remember, I left on what would have been the 8th turn.
Oh, I don't even look care.
Damn.
My score is a massive 328.
I'm proud of it.
I don't know if that's good or bad.
I think that's bad.
Yeah, it's screw the score.
I think it's amazing because it's a victory.
I don't even know what it's really. So, God, that was cool.
Well, that's a lot of characters that we couldn't use in campaign mode if we were playing campaign.
No doubt.
Yeah. It's like half of Middle Earth.
If we were playing campaign, what cards could we have brought to this in terms of boons and stuff?
Well, we would have had the class boons and their upgrades, or someone would have had +1 to everything and immune to encounter cards.
Right.
So, we
would have had
Mary,
like a couple
obviously.
Characters probably would have been boosted a little bit.
Is it 3 golden hairs, lower threat, and each player draws 3 cards? That would have been bloody handy right about now.
Once per campaign.
Yeah, but it's like 5 quests away from finishing. If you're not going to use it, I mean, I'm the first person who doesn't use consumables in video games and ends up dying with 15 potions of healing. But yeah.
It's such a thing. Why do we hoard them?
I don't know.
I use the boon at, I forget which one it is. It's basically a test of will.
The Tom Bombadil one.
Yeah, Ho Tom
right.
Bombadil.
I use that at Helm's Deep.
That's what we have been saving it for.
And I was like, I've carried this thing for so long. And I'm like, but I have to use it or I'm losing.
Yeah.
It saved me, but Sean, I felt like weird using it.
Yes.
Sean, what made you want to use this quest for tonight? What made you want to do it?
Well, it was the first quest in kind of release order that we haven't done yet. I also haven't played Pelennor Fields, and I don't like learning a quest on Twitch because that often spells disaster. And I actually quite like this one. Pretty big fan of how the first quest stage starts out. Yep, obviously I gushed about it at the beginning, but the fact that they brought that old Dol Guldur mechanic back and somehow made it work was pretty cool for me. And it feels good.
The other thing that would have been different in campaign is that the campaign card for this quest says every player can raise their threat by 1 for the first player to put Andaril in their hand first turn.
Ooh.
Mm.
Which would have been handy, I think, because Aragorn would have been like ballistic out of the gate without Andaril on him.
For sure.
Right.
He would have never known.
Yeah.
So, I was just like curious that you chose like a campaign card or a campaign quest. So.
Yeah, I don't know. I think I tend to play most of the saga boxes as one-offs. Like, I've toyed with campaign, and I've played a few times through it. I think Dave and I are through, like, my actual longest continuous play through it, and we're only at, what? We just beat Breaking of the Fellowship?
Yeah, we've just got to start Land of Shadow, right?
Yeah. So, and it's kind of weird because you think, like, for the Saga Quest, it makes so much more sense to play it in Saga mode, but I actually tend to approach the Saga Quests in one-off mode more often than not, so.
After playing that second box, I think it's worse, just because I think if I'd have played those quests in campaign mode first, those boons and burdens would have just put me off playing them again, because they're so horrible.
Hmm. From
5 burdens, don't we, in campaign mode? So, like, our break of the Fellowship Darkens? Was... Yeah. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, I totally do agree with you that I felt a turn in kind of the Road Darkens box that the burdens got more powerful than the boons.
Because they're all surge.
Yeah, they're all really terrible, and you see them a lot, even in 2-player. But yeah. I can't speak to how it plays through the rest of the campaign because things get removed and things get added and
yeah.
So I just can't speak to it yet, but definitely felt that way at the beginning.
Yeah,
well,
definitely.
Road Darkens, you only choose 1. Right?
Yeah, but we got 1. Didn't
choose
we pick
one
up
what?
Like
You only choose one of the burdens and the road darkens, right?
Yeah, but we picked up three for the Ford.
Oh yeah,
okay, right. Yeah, I only had one on that one. Okay, then yes. Yes. That's a lot of
That's lucky though, because don't you get one for traveling to a mandatory location in that, don't you?
You get one for sure, yep.
Yeah, so that's, I mean, one is pretty lucky.
There's people who do it with none, because then they get it out of the encounter.
Or they remove it, yeah.
Right.
Oh my god.
Yeah, I'm definitely hashtagging quality shown here.
Such cheese.
Quality show.
Yeah, I think the biggest ones for me are the ones that continuously start in the staging area. I think it's Stricken by Grief.
Right.
But I don't feel like that one's the worst out of all of them, because you've got Gloin.
Well, that just happens to be for our fellowship. Without Gloin, that card sucks more.
Yeah, a lot more.
But yeah, I don't know. I did feel there was a bit of a turn where I felt like the boons weren't doing as much for us as the burdens were doing for the encounter deck.
Not even close. Because you don't get the upgrades till the end of the box, do you? You get them taken into Buruk Hai, right?
You get the artifacts at Elrond's Council at the beginning of the first quest.
Yeah, but that's the worst part about that whole box, is that you get them on the first quest and then you start with them. And then they get shuffled into your deck, so you might see them.
Yeah, as one-offs, which really hurts it. So, yep.
Yeah. Oh, well. Right, it's 4:45, so I'm going to bed.
Yep.
Yeah, buddy. That was a great game.
That was a really good game. GG's, boys. I'm sure we made some mistakes somewhere, but I think overall that was a really solid show.
Yeah, just don't read the YouTube comments.
Well.
If people...
They've been pretty civil of late, so I have faith.
Go back and watch. So,
yeah.
All right. Well, thanks, Dave, for coming on. Any parting shots?
Oh yeah, Pocket Wraith has it. Pocket Wraith got it. That's how it is.
Don't drink in quests.
You know, I'm actually okay with it. It's turned out pretty well for me. We won. My counterintuitive Gandalf Raise Your Threat deck was actually kind of effective against the...
I think you should go back and watch the... When you put go back and watch the discussion when you go for a pee, and how we bash you for playing Gandalf on turn one.
It worked! We won! It's okay. Daniel, thanks for coming on. Any kind of PSs on the way out here?
No, this was a fantastic... event, and I thank you very much for, you know, letting me participate.
Yeah, man.
Absolutely, thanks for coming up, man.
Chad?
Yep.
Epic quest. Just happy to be a part of it. Epic, epic, epic.
Yeah, really, really good game. Well, I think that's it for us tonight, then. Funny story.
And song.
You broke up there, Daniel.
Oh, I said I want Sean to end this with a song, because Eowyn's death...
Haven't we suffered enough?
So, I want everyone who's here to know that I've been trying to work on getting episode 104 up and into the RSS and onto the website, but I haven't quite been able to do it because Brandon's been gone, and it's kind of like... Have you ever... entered a job where you're the only other person to like touch it in like 5 years, and you're trying to pick up the process and you have no idea where to start or end? Yeah, that's where I'm at, trying to figure out like exactly how to get everything up through the COTR infrastructure in the proper way. So hopefully that'll be up in the next couple days. It's a really fun episode. It's our post Gen Con episode. Fun stories to be had. So I'm excited for that one to hit.
You can skip the last, like, seven or 8 minutes.
No, you definitely can't, because Chad goes ahead and makes for some of his best moments yet on COTR. And, you just definitely don't want to miss it.
Speaking of suicide. Speaking of suicide.
Does Chad have his spider-esque moment?
Oh, I wish. I wish. That would have been fantastic.
Yep. Yeah.
Let's just say that once again, something I said, I think, became the show title. And yeah.
Nice.
We'll leave it at that.
We'll see, right. Chad. I went with the PG version, which was not based on that. But when Brandon gets back, I would not fault him for changing it straight back to the joke.
Oh, for love of God, John, please get this thing.
No, the harder you fight it, the harder it's going to stick. That's just how it works.
Oh man.
Anyway,
that's all right. Anything for the cast.
Look forward to that in the next couple days. If I can't get it up today or tomorrow, then hopefully Brandon will have it up by the weekend. Otherwise,
cut that video, please. Someone cut that out of the video, please.
Okay, what happened?
If you can't get it up in the next couple of days.
Oh my lord. Well, okay, that happened. And you know what? I'm just gonna stick with it because love thyself, right? Or love thy brand.
Oh my
god.
Surely that you're gonna have trouble doing that if you can't get it up to the next couple of days.
Chad, take us out.
Hey, everybody. See you next time on COTR Twitch and listen for the next podcast, episode 104.